A couple of weeks ago, you said the guys didn't have their clocks wound right. This is usually their opener.
Now there's no time for alibis, Brian. Nothing to fall back on. But Cleveland has one built in. We have just found out that Greg Pruitt, their star running back, will be out for today's contest as they go for three in a row against the Atlanta Falcons.
Okay, before we get into today, let's clean up yesterday. They call him Alexander the Great down south. His name is Charles Alexander. He's a Heisman Trophy candidate. And last night, he led the Bayou Bengals of LSU to a 24-17 win over the Indiana Hoosiers. Michael, he's something else. He's got 144 yards and two touchdowns, 215 pounds.
Well, Brian, he is the best thing to happen to LSU and Charlie McClendon since Burt Jones, and he is also making, and it's really tough to do, he's making fans forget Billy Cannon, the great LSU legend.
There was another big debut yesterday. Arch Sleaster, the freshman of Ohio State, but it was a losing effort at Columbus, 19-0, the Nittany Lions. When was the last time Woody put the ball in the air 30 times?
I don't think since Wallace Berry played tugboat Annie. And he also started a freshman, which is really very rare for Woody Hayes.
Other scores, the Mike Ford leads the SMU Mustangs, and they've got a football team. Just ask the Gators. 10-point differential in Florida. And Air Force sprang a surprise at Chestnut Hill. They beat BC. The final count on that one was 18-7. Let's change it up just a little bit and go to baseball. The four contenders in the American League met in two crucial games deciding divisional battles yesterday. Right here, the Yankees beat the Boston Red Sox 3-2, continuing the Red Sox late season collapse. It was 2-2 in the ninth inning when Mickey Rivers led off against Mike Torres with a triple up the alley. Before Gary Hancock could chase it down when the ball had rolled to a stop, Mick the Quick had rounded second and cruised on into third to provide the Yankees with a lead run and nobody out. With the infield drawn in, Thurman Munson picked on a 1-2 pitch, looped it into right center, and Jimmy Rice did all he could with it. He caught it, but certainly it wasn't enough for the Red Sox. Mickey Rivers cruised home, giving the Yankees a 3.5-game lead in the American East. That's the same lead the Kansas City Royals hold over the Angels today in the American West. The Angels pulled a come-from-behind yesterday. They were down 3-1 in the eighth inning, facing Al Roboski. Carney Lansford, the batter with two men on, he takes Roboski up and over the wall in left center to provide the Angels with a 4-3 lead that never relinquished. Were the Royals and Roboski mad? I guess. Watch this one. First pitch, a message to Lyman Bostock. He says, that's cool. That's part of the game, but this one is not. Not behind my head. You and me, on the mat we will go, and on the mat they did go. Roboski against Bostock, everybody joined in. Typical baseball fight, though. A lot of shoving, a lot of pushing, a lot of ejections, and absolutely no one was hurt. And the baseball races will continue today, and you'll be able to see it right here on NFL 78. We'll be bringing you highlights of the Red Sox-Yankees affair as they try to decide the title in the American League East. We'll get back to football, and we'll do it by looking at a controversy right after this.
I could stand here and just talk about all the great new Olds models for 1979. Talk about the elegant new Toronado, for example. Talk about this stylish new Cutlass, now with an available diesel V8. But all that talk wouldn't hold a candle to one test drive. A test drive where you discover that great Olds feeling, because a test drive is worth 1,000 words.
These new Oldsmobiles go on sale September 28th. But make an appointment today at your Olds dealer and discover that great Olds feeling.
Ooh, I'm sorry.
There's so much information in the Yellow Pages, you'll never be caught with your pants down. You'll even locate maps that are tailor-made to help you.
I see you right around the corner.
Just hold still.
It's all right. Yeah, all right.
When you need to know who, what, where, when, and why, let your fingers do the walking through the Bell System Yellow Pages.
It's bad enough I got a dent in my kitchen. Now I gotta face the insurance hassle.
You don't with the good hands, people. We take the hassle out of claims.
Sure you do.
Allstate people treat you right.
I hear you had a little problem with your camper.
It was a tree.
And we settle most damage claims on the spot.
This'll fix it.
Do we take the hassle out of claims? You bet we do.
My kind of people.
When there's a way to take the hassle out of claims, Allstate will do it.
And that's a promise from us. The good hands people.
Unless you have spent the last week living in a cave, you would have heard football fans this week talking about the officiating. And, Michael, the first bad call that people have been talking about occurred in San Diego last week. How do you feel as a player when it happens?
Well, if you're a player, Brian, you're very frustrated, especially if you're a San Diego Charger and dominate a team the way the Chargers did Oakland. But I think what all players would like to see is that the NFL officiating position become full-time year-round.
All right, let's turn back the clock a little bit to last Sunday. The Chargers are leading 20-14. There are only seconds left in the ball game. We get the call, as it happened, from our Jim Simpson.
Bradshaw wide to the right. Stabler back to throw. Stabler is now being harassed for the first time at the top of the ball. Ball is loose, still loose. Picked up, kick into the end zone. And we'll see what happens. Oh, Sydney, touchdown! Can you believe it? Touchdown Raiders!
Our film really doesn't show it all that plainly, but the videotape we got shows it very plainly. Lois has Stabler in his grasp. Stabler's facing our goal line. Lowe's pushing him back. He left-handed underhand threw the ball forward about 5.5 yards. And
everybody's asking me about, well, did you throw it? Did you try to lateral it? Did you pass it? Or what'd you do? You just do something. You don't have anything in mind. And then the referee calls it. You don't plan anything like that. The only thing in my mind was don't get sacked with the ball, because if you do, the game's over. 10 seconds left, no timeouts. You get sacked, so I didn't want to keep the ball.
It was very obvious that Kenny Stabler threw the ball underhanded. He threw it forward. He admitted it in the newspapers. In interviews, he said that he deliberately fumbled forward. That should have been ruled an incompleted forward pass.
I can only say that when you look at the film, I think it's in the eye of the beholder.
Then Banaszak recovered the ball, got it in both hands, and he threw it forward about 8 yards.
And we broke the huddle over 10 seconds left. So, if I pick the ball up, he tackles me and the ball game's over there anyway. Yeah, I knew what the game situation was, and I just, hit it and drove the goal line.
Banaszak, their fullback, picked up the ball and heaved it, threw it toward the San Diego goal line.
I can only say, in looking at the film, I did not think it was so clear that it was a blatant error by an official in judgment not to have called it. I wish it had been called, but I certainly would not say that it was a blatant error. It was close enough that I could understand why it wasn't called.
Casper juggled it into the end zone and recovered it, and the officials ruled a touchdown.
I believe it was an atrocious series of calls, and I hope that the NFL responds to my protest.
But there will be no response to Klein's protest, because there's no protest procedure in the NFL. Question is, should there be?
It might be that a provision for protest should be put in the rules for certain specific things that might occur. And I think it will be discussed at our annual meeting in March.
On the night after that call was made in San Diego, there was another controversial call. This one occurred in Minnesota, and it also could have decided a game. Michael, I understand you backed the officials with this one.
Bryant, there was two consecutive calls. The initial one was correct. Don Wedge signaled that Weiss was tackled behind the line of scrimmage, and of course, the clock stops.
As we watch it, let's take a look. Perhaps the culprit is Nate Allen of the Vikings, who picked up the ball and stopped Wedge from actually allowing the play to continue. Let's pick it up. Weiss is in charge of the offense. The Broncos are trailing by 3 points when he rolls out, viewed as a passer by Wedge. How did the Broncos get their kicking team on the field? Here's a possible explanation.
In Minnesota, they have a unique situation. It's the only stadium we have wherein both teams are on the same side of the field. So this occurred virtually in front of the Denver bench. And Denver only had to get 4 substitutes in for their kicking team. The official took a new ball over to the hash mark, put it down. Players were there. He signaled the play to start, and the snap of the center occurred prior to time expiring, so the play was still live, and the field goal was kicked.
And so it is that names like Wedge and Mark Wright have replaced Staubach and Jones as the most talked about names in the NFL. We'll continue to look at the referees, and next week John Brody will have a commentary on officiating in the NFL. Perhaps it is the officials are overmatched. Speaking of overmatched, my friend here spent the week with some cheerleaders. I know you won't want to miss it after this.
Once upon a time, Goldilocks went looking for a sleep sofa that was comfortable both day and night. And everyone she saw was just right. The right color, the right style. Because everyone was a lazy sleeper by Lazy Boy, with quality and comfort, so each one was just right. And she lived happily ever after. The Lazy Boy Lazy Sleeper for the rest of your life.
Danish heritage of American brewed Tuborg Gold. Never go for bronze or silver. Live to make the most of every day. Go for the gold. Then taste the triumph of Danish brewing. Tuborg Gold.
You make the most of every day. Go for the gold. Tuborg Gold.
I've got to be honest with you. It says right here that I am supposed to, at this point, lead into a cheerleader feature, but instead I've got a question, which is, how did you get the assignment?
Brian, how quickly you forget. You lost a toss. You don't remember that. You know, cheerleading is as much a part of the NFL as the forward pass, but it's not all tinsel and glamour. There's a lot of hard work, as I found out earlier.
They're called the Dallas Cowboy Cheerleaders, and they started it all. That's not to say they were the first, because most NFL teams have had cheerleaders for some time. But the Cowboys 36 made cheerleading big business, and even the most diehard of football fans will have to admit, cheerleading is here to stay. In Chicago, the Honey Bears elicit as many oohs and ahs as does Walter Payton. And for hours a night, several nights a week, these girls learn and rehearse strictly choreographed dance routines and cheers, which they showcase on Sunday afternoon.
Patty, what prompts a girl to become a cheerleader? You do this for very little money and a lot of long hours of practice. How come?
Well, first of all, I've always liked football. I'm a diehard Bear fan.
I like football. I love football, and I was a cheerleader in high school.
I love football.
I think, first of all, you have to have a basic love for football.
I have even gotten more involved in football.
I think that we're an inspiration to the team.
Because I am a cheerleader at heart.
After playing in the NFL and demonstrating limited coordination on the playing field, I wanted to see if I could play ball with the pros on the sidelines.
Ladies, I'm just a dumb football player, and I had trouble when I played chewing gum and walking or running at the same time. Can I learn this at all?
You sure can.
Seriously.
Yeah, anybody can.
Oh, show me.
Sure. And after a few minutes of instruction, I was ready to join the chorus line.
I've had enough.
What? Really? Yes.
Talk about the ultimate in participatory journalism. George Plimpton eats your heart out. Heaven.
At the risk of getting thrown off the air, getting thrown out of the house by June Gumbel, Michael, I am speechless.
I don't think John Travolta has to worry, Brian, but I'd like to deliver a special plaudit to our cameraman, Barry Winnick, who in the face of all that pawkertude was able to hold his hand oh so steady.
Somehow or other, I'm supposed to make a smooth transition from that to what I've got to do, but we'll try it anyway. As part of NBC's continuing coverage leading up to the Moscow Games of 1980, we're going to be bringing you Olympic moments about what has happened and what is happening in the Olympic movement. As part of that, we take time out right now to bring you this Olympic moment.
This Olympic moment is brought to you by the Bell System. When it comes to solving business communications problems, the system is the solution.
Helsinki, 1952. The opening day ceremonies of the 15th Olympiad. Following day, the final of the 10,000-meter run. The favorite in the race, Emil Zatopek, a major in the Czechoslovakian army. The runners will travel the 400-meter track 25 times. At the end of 25 laps, Zatopek has lapped nearly every runner in the race. He wins the gold medal and breaks the Olympic record. 2 days later, the final of the 5,000-meter run. With 200 meters to go, Emil Zatopek is in fourth place. He starts his final sprint. Emil Zatopek first. He wins his second gold medal. On the last day of competition, Emil Zatopek enters the 26-mile, 385-yard marathon. It is the first time he has ever run in this event. In a little more than 2 hours, Zatopek is the first man into the stadium. Emil Zatopek. The only man in Olympic history to win the classic long-distance events, the 10,000 meters, 5,000 meters, and historic marathon run.
Problem? Credit verification in a hurry.
Can you hurry it up, please? My plane leaves in 2 minutes.
I'm doing the best I can, sir.
The Bell System solution. A system that verifies credit in seconds.
My plane leaves in 4 minutes. Can I make it?
No problem.
Now ready for departure. 5:23, now boarding.
That's it?
That's it. There you go.
Thanks.
Another case that shows the system is the solution.
We spoke earlier of the disappointment the Chargers experienced last Sunday, but the fact that the San Diego Chargers can experience disappointment, Mike, is an indication that they are indeed back.
It's a good sign, Brian. There are no patsies in the AFC West, and if you look at young talent, San Diego may have the best.
I say back because the Chargers in the old days of the AFL were a championship team. But since the merger, they fell on hard times, lost a lot, went through a drug scandal, but they are back, certainly in the mind of owner Gene Klein.
We went through the birth pains. We went through the agony of losing 11 straight games, a couple of years ago before we won our first game. We played the rookies, the youngsters.
You know, I don't think it would have been much fun to be here when the Chargers were going through the bad years with, you know, they had the big scandal and stuff.
When the Chargers won the AFL title in 1963, the lineup was star-studded. One was the great receiver Hall of Famer Lance Allworth. He still watches, this time from the safety of the stands.
We were winners, and we knew we could win. And I just feel like that the guys that are coming in now and the team that that they're putting together now are starting to feel that way. In fact, with the addition of Mitchell, I was hoping with the leader that he is, that they will get more of a feeling from him even, and that maybe we'll get them over the hump, because that's all they need is just a little something.
Somewhat reminds me of the 75... Baltimore Colts. We were young. We didn't know what winning was all about. And still, this team doesn't know what winning is all about until you get out there and you experience winning 3 or 4 or 5, 6 games in a row. And then you know that you're a good football team. You go out and you say, well, we know we can win each week.
The first move that was made was the hiring of Tommy Prothrow, who has done a magnificent job both in coaching and perhaps more importantly in gathering the talent and selecting the talent for this club.
We've been very fortunate in the draft. I think we've made a few good trades, and I think our players have developed, and I think we're very competitive.
What's encouraging the Charger fans now is not just that the team is competitive right now, but it has great young stars like number 83 rookie John Jefferson.
He has an amazing talent, and his presence on that field means an awful lot to the Chargers offense, even if when they don't throw it to him. He's a tremendous athlete. I enjoy watching him.
He is certainly the most outstanding young receiver I've ever seen.
In 1975, we drafted 8 players who are starters or on our team today. The trades helped us. The 1978 draft has given us John Jefferson, one of the outstanding players in the game. You can see in the players the excitement, the anticipation, the pulling together and the doing it. And we know that 1978 is the beginning of Charger time.
We'll be watching the continuing progress of the Chargers today as they go against last year's Cinderella team, the Denver Broncos, today in another big AFC Western matchup. We're getting close to kickoff time. Down on the field, they're just about ready. NFL 78 will go down to the field after these messages from your local stations.
Disney's 25th year celebration continues with the enchanting story of Dumbo, shown for the first time in 15 years. Then, the spectacular conclusion of King Kong, the most colossal film adventure of all time. King Kong, as you've never seen him before. Tonight at 9, 8 Central, right after Dumbo on NBC.
Sunday, a businessman must juggle a demanding wife, a strong-minded mother, and a mistress in A Time for Loving.
Oh my God. A quarter to. I've got an important guest for lunch at home. I'll see you tonight.
We'll have lots of time.
Be true to me till then.
Time for Loving, Sunday night at 11:30.
Hello, I'm Dick Klinger, and I'd like to tell you about some of the interesting guests that we have lined up for Seattle tonight, this coming week. Dr. Alan Nourse, who writes the Good Housekeeping Doctors column, will be here, along with John Lindsay, who's the former mayor of New York City, and the man who's the president of Pacific Northwest Bell Telephone Company, in our efforts to provide you with probably 30 minutes a night of interesting, provocative conversation on Seattle tonight.
Takes 30 minutes to get from SeaTac downtown.
People coming in from Bashan Island to see the show.
From Olympia coming in.
It's good to see the show.
From the base of Queen Anne.
People from Bremerton said they try to get the early ferry. They have kids.
Might be some people up from Tacoma or Vancouver tonight.
And my friends from Queen Anne.
You're watching KING-TV, Seattle.
Today, a matchup of two of the NFL's superb young quarterbacks, Richard Todd of the New York Jets, who shares the NFL lead with Roger Staubach with 6 touchdowns. And Jim Zorn of the Seattle Seahawks, 4th in AFC passing statistics, a young man being compared to Fran Tarkenton of the Minnesota Vikings. Hi, everybody. I'm Marv Albert, along with Bob Trumpy, the one-time All-Pro for the Cincinnati Bengals. And, Bob, you can certainly relate to the offensive show that we expect this afternoon between the two young quarterbacks, Zorn and Todd.
Now, I like an offensive football game, and today we're going to see one of the best, especially through the air. Let's talk about the receivers. You talked about the quarterbacks. For the Jets, Wesley Walker, a second-round draft choice in 1977 from California. This guy has burner speed. He gets deep and gets deep consistently. He beat Miami twice deep in the Jets' opening win of the 1978 season. I think we can expect Richard Todd to go to him several times very deep. And for the Seattle Seahawks, on the other side of the coin, Steve Largent, Jim Zorn's favorite receiver. Not as fast as Wesley Walker, but compared to Howard Twilley. Very consistent receiver, good patterns, great hands. And he won't go as deep as will Wesley Walker, but we'll see Jim Zorn throw him the ball a lot today.
All right, the Seahawks come in with a record of 0-2 and two tough losses. In fact, last week at Pittsburgh, they ended the fourth quarter trailing the Steelers only 14-10. While the Jets are off to one of their best starts in years, they are 2-0, upset victory over Miami, followed up by the win in the final seconds against Buffalo in Buffalo last week, a victory that even Jet players admit they were very fortunate to come away with. And, Bob, an interesting matchup of coaches, Walt Michaels for the New York Jets, Jack Patera for the Seattle Seahawks.
And we're talking offense all afternoon here, but these two coaches are defensive strategists. Patera put together the fearsome foursome for Los Angeles. He put together the Purple People Eaters in Minnesota. Walt Michaels was an all-pro linebacker with the Cleveland Browns. These guys want defense, but they've got offense, and that's what they'll play with today.
And we should see fireworks this afternoon here at Shea. Jim Zorn of the Seattle Seahawks quarterbacking his young ball club, and Mr. Todd quarterbacking the young New York Jets. And we'll be back with all the action in just a couple of minutes. Let's hear these messages.
And the tempo takes control. And the
Danish heritage of American brewed Tuborg Gold. Never go for bronze or silver. Live to make the most of every day. Go for the gold. Then taste the triumph of Danish brewing. Tuborg Gold.
You make the most of every day. Go for the gold. Tuborg Gold.
You're looking at a few reasons why some young families think they can't afford life insurance. Glasses, braces, clothes, bikes. At Allstate Life, we understand. One solution is our new policy that helps close the gap between what young families need and what they can afford. The Gap Closer. 6 years of renewable and convertible term insurance to help you get through the struggling years. Ask your Allstate agent about it. You're in good hands with Allstate.
This is the famous design of Oldsmobile's Cutlass Supreme. It's one big reason why more mid-sized car buyers chose Cutlass over the last 4 years than any other car. But there's another reason. Cutlass is different cars for different people. Those who want style, value, and good gas mileage choose Cutlass Supreme. Those who like the look and feel of a grand touring car choose Cutlass Calais with bucket seats, special suspension, and full instrumentation. Those who want the nicest of luxury touches choose Cutlass Supreme Brougham with richness inside you'd expect in bigger, more expensive cars. Cutlass, different cars for different people. All of them come with that solid Olds engineering and that great Cutlass feeling on the road. Millions of Cutlass owners know the feeling and love it. Why don't you take a test drive at your Oldsmobile dealer now and discover that great Cutlass feeling too? Olds Cutlass Supreme. Have one built for you.
The race for the 1980 Olympics has already begun. The games in Moscow are just the last lap of a long, grueling race that's going on right now. We've got the talent, but we need your support. Because America doesn't send athletes to the Olympics, Americans do. Don't let our team get caught short. Send a contribution to U.S. Olympic Committee, Box 1980N, Cathedral Station, Boston. For contributions of $10 or more, you'll receive this antique brass Olympic belt buckle. This message furnished by the U.S. Olympic Committee.
The executive producer of NFL 78 is Don Ohlmeyer. Today's show was produced by Don McGuire. Directed by Steve Rosen. Technical director, Len Greenberg. Associate director, Jim Robertson. In New York, produced by Sam Kirschman. Directed by Jim Cross. Technical director, Bruce Berquist. Coming up next from Shea Stadium in New York, the Seattle Seahawks and the New York Jets.
NBC Sports presents the best of the National Football League, the American Football Conference. To you by your Chrysler Plymouth dealers, where you can add a little life to your style with a new size Chrysler LeBaron. By new Schlitz Light Natural Pilsner Beer, still less filling with a taste that's bigger than light. And by AC Delco, quality automotive parts for quality motoring. Go with the names you know. AC Delco.
Stadium, Marv Albert and Bob Crumpy as we get set for the Jets and the Seahawks kickoff. The referee is Gordon McCarter. The umpire is Tony Kramer. The head linesman, Jerry Seaman. The line judge is Jack Fitty. The back judge, Ray Douglas. The side judge, Bill Quimby. And the field judge is Armin Terzian. The Jets won the toss. They will receive as you look at Efren Herrera tee it up for Seattle. And back deep, Bruce Hopper, number 42, and Bruce Stevens,
Hopper averaging 28 yards for six kickoffs, off to a sensational start, matching last year's performance, and Stevens, a free agent rookie from Columbia University. Jets and the Seahawks. The Seahawks winning here last year by the score of 17-0, and Herrera will have to tee it up once again. 70 degrees, sunny and mild here in New York. The high expect to hit the mid-70s. Wind factor is minimal, which is most unusual for Shea Stadium. Gets a block. And a beautiful second effort bringing it across the 35-yard line. It appeared the Seahawks had him down earlier. And finally, John Sawyer and Don Testament were able to bring him down. So the Jets will go to work now. And that Jet backfield with Kevin Long, a starter this year, after seeing limited action last year.
And there's one of the best combinations of receivers there is in football, with Barkham at tight end for the Jets today. Watch Walker, he'll go deep on you.
Now that is Gaffney in motion. Play action from the start as Todd goes sideline. And Todd has got a first down with his running back, Scott Durkin. Sammy Green, the linebacker on the left side, and the left cornerback, Cornell Webster, bringing him down.
Barb, I'll tell you what, we'll watch any kind of offensive pass receiving today that you can imagine. Chris Ward and Marvin Powell, the two tackles there, they call them the bookends. And Randy Rasmussen, 12-year veteran, the oldest guy on the team.
Got a quick glimpse of that defensive line with Bill Gregory getting his first start. Came from the Dallas Cowboys just a couple of weeks ago. First down for the Jets. Dirking and Long, the running back. And this is Kevin Long. Across midfield. Long is a second-year pro out of the University of South Carolina. Had his best day as a pro last week with 74 yards against Buffalo. The linebackers for Seattle. Keith Butler making his first professional start. Teaming up with Green and Beeson.
And those defensive backs are going to be tested today, Marv. They got to get deep because New York is going to throw it.
Second and about five. That is Kirking, number 25, in motion. And Todd to throw again. Got the screen for Long. Kevin Long picking up the first down.
Marv, the Jets are 2-0 coming into this football game, and they beat Miami in the first game, and they beat Buffalo in the second game, and they said they were lucky last week, but this team has come alive behind Richard Todd, and of course, Walt Michaels takes a great deal of credit. Because the team throws the ball down the field so much, screens are an excellent part of New York's offense. Also draws. Excellent, excellent play, and lots of good second effort there by Long.
All right, Bob, the Jets have a first down at the Seattle 39, opening minutes of play from Shea Stadium in New York. And Todd again to the air. This time he's going long. And he overthrows Wesley Walker. Walker was covered step by step by the right cornerback, Dave Brown.
But Richard Todd will throw it down there 8, 10, 15 times a day. And every once in a while, he'll complete one. And a lot of them to Wesley Walker. This is a real aerial show.
Richard right behind Terry Bradshaw, the Pittsburgh Steelers, in AFC statistics. As we told you at the top, he's thrown 6 touchdowns in 2 games. Last year, an injury plague year, threw 11 in 12 games. It is a 2nd and 10 at the Seattle 39. As the Jets shift Durkin and Long out of the regular pro set. Kevin Long on a reverse, again able to elude tacklers and pick up yardage. It appeared that he was trapped back behind the line. Dave Brown making the stop.
This is the old Statue of Liberty play. I like it. This is out of somebody's playbook that's very old. Look at that. That's the way they used to do it when Jim Thorpe played football. Yeah. I like the effort of Kevin Long. Tremendous. Look at Seattle's out there, though.
Kevin Long, who has come a long way from 1977. Picked up six. It is a third and four at the Seattle 33-yard line. Safety Autry Beeman and the Jets have a first and goal.
Now I want to tell you, this has got to be a defensive coach's nightmare to try to stop either one of these offenses. Jerome Barkham, when they double cover the outside receivers, Barkham's got to be open right down the middle. Todd puts it on the money, and Jerome is an excellent receiver, has been for years. They moved him to tight end when Rich Caster left, and he played tight end last year. That guy can catch the football. A defensive coach's nightmare, this one's going to be.
Now, those are high marks from one-time All-Pro tight end Bob Crumby. First and goal at the six. And Richard Todd wants to talk it over. He saw something he did not like and decided to call for time, so they'll huddle up once again.
That's smart. That's smart. Richard Todd has not played a lot of professional football. He's got a very young team out there. He wants to make sure that everything goes right. He goes to Walt Michaels to talk it over.
Giving us an opportunity to tell you that this telecast is presented by authority of the National Football League, and it is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the New York Jets and the National Football League is prohibited. Well, Todd off to a fast start. He is 3 for 4 for 48 yards.
Marv, I'll tell you, last year in the 1977 statistics for the NFL, the New York Jets ranked 27th out of 28 teams in defense. 26th, excuse me. And the Seattle Seahawks were 27th. These teams do not play defense. They rely on scoring a lot of points. Richard Todd has become the leader of this football team. Very, very similar to number 12 that used to play for the Jets. Although Richard Todd doesn't own a fur coat.
Yeah.
He doesn't own a restaurant. He doesn't live in Manhattan. He lives on Long Island. Really at the insistence of Coach Walt Michaels. He's a lot more low-key. He's from Alabama, and Joe Namath was his hero. That guy's destined to have his own TV series on NBC if he stays here long enough.
You sound like you're looking to produce it. Wait a second, bud.
No, that's what happens to New York Jet quarterbacks. They get shows on NBC, Waverly's Wonders. There he is, Mr. Todd.
Well, Richard sat out last year's 17-0 loss to Seattle because of a knee injury. Jets have controlled the football over these first 4 minutes. They have a first and goal down at the six. We have no score. Long and Durkin, the running back. And that is Scott Durkin on the slant. So Durkin on his first carry. He is a second-year pro out of Purdue. Goes 5'10", 215 pounds, and he was stopped by number 77, Bill Gregory.
There's the Seattle defense. Bill Gregory, just acquired from the Dallas Cowboys in a trade. And that's a man that can do an awful lot of good for this young team. Very young team out there, but they can play defense.
It is a second and goal down at the three as they line up tight. And Clark Gaines, who checked in, replacing Kevin Long, getting the call, stopped by Niehaus and Butler. So Gaines brings it down to the one-yard line.
The Jets have yet to score a touchdown on the ground. This may be their first one. Chances are, though, they'll probably throw it, right? We'll see.
It is a third and goal now from the one. The crowd urging the Jets on. Inserting the running back and the holding it. Clark Gaines with the Jets' first rushing score. The three-year pro out of Wake Forest, who was hit by injuries during the course of preseason, lost his starting job to Kevin Long, brings it home right here.
That is right over Randy Rasmussen and the number one draft choice, Chris Ward. That's their first touchdown on the ground, as Marv told you. Yes, sir. For inches, he makes it.
Now Pat Leahy, who has had a terrific start. He is 4 for 4 in field goals. Now make it 7 for 7 for points after. And the New York Jets, here are the opening moments of play at Shea, have taken a 7-0 lead on the Seahawks of Seattle.
style. And so does the new size Chrysler LeBaron. A lean, young look, plus add-ons like real leather, add life to any lifestyle. Chrysler class. Yet sticker priced like Cutlass Supreme, comparably equipped.
Add a little life to your style.
Chrysler LeBaron. Add a little life to your style.
These are two of today's newest razors. The one on the right is the new Norelco Rechargeable Rotary Razor. This one has two blades and pivots up and down. The new Norelco 36 blades in three adjustable floating heads and a new shaving angle. Both give you a close shave. But the new Norelco Rechargeable lets you walk away from soap and water. Of course, they do give you one thing Norelco doesn't. Gotcha. The new Norelco Rechargeable Rotary Razor. Still no gotcha.
Off a combination of Richard Todd passing and a ground game, the New York Jets, within 5 minutes and 9 seconds, nine plays, 65 yards, have taken a 7-0 lead on Seattle's Ferguson. And Rufus Crawford are back for this Pat Leahy kickoff. It is Ferguson to the 20, to the 25, and across the 30-yard line as the Seahawks touch the ball for the first time this afternoon. Mike Mock, backup linebacker, making the stop for the New York Jets. The Seattle Seahawks with Jim Zorn at quarterback, Al Hunter replacing the injured Sherman Smith, who will be out for three more weeks, and Don Testament.
And those receivers will get just as much of work out as the Jets receivers. You'll see the same type of offense. There's the offensive line right there.
And it's a first down at the 32 as Zorn checks it over. And he will throw on first down, goes the middle, and he is just shy of a first down out of the 40 as he hits Al Hunter, who was stopped by number 52, Mike Hennigan.
Okay, last week when Seattle played Pittsburgh, Jack Lambert, the middle linebacker of the Pittsburgh Steelers, paid Jim Zorn a great compliment, saying that he's one of the best quarterbacks in the NFL at scrambling. Left-handed, obviously he can throw, and they will throw it to anybody on the field. They have a very diverse offense, as does the Jets. Very exciting game.
And Lambert also said he may be the best quarterback of the National Football League. That is McCullum out to the right as they line up in the eye. Second and two from the Seattle 40-yard line. Nice fake, Al Hunter stopped. It appears to be short of a first down. Number 73, a name you will hear throughout the afternoon. Second-year man, Joe Klecko, making the stop. Jet defensive line, and they go out of the 3-4 this year with the nose tackle Abdul Salam in the middle.
And Greg Buttle, the middle linebacker there. He is one of the best there is in the league.
It is a third and one. Now David Sims has come on, replacing Al Hunter. Sims and Testament on the running back. And the handoff is for Sims. He's got the first down and more. Lawrence Pillars, number 76, a three-year pro out of Alcorn State, making the stop on Sims. Burgess Owens, free safety, also in on the tackle. So the Seahawks with their first down of the afternoon.
And this is a very, very young defensive unit. I believe that Burgess Owens is the oldest guy on the team defensively with 6 years' experience in the NFL.
In fact, their left cornerback, Bobby Jackson, is only 21 years old. Zorn off the short set. Quick square out completed to Steve Largent. Followed out by number 38, Ed Taylor. So Largent with his first reception.
Yeah, you might as well get a bunch of potato chips and Cokes and sit there, because this is going to be throwing the ball all day long. Largent is Zorn's favorite receiver. Now, Largent's coach in college was Jerry Rome, and he is now the offensive coordinator for the Seattle Seahawks. 10 touchdowns last year he scored. Only Nat Moore of Miami had more with 12.
And that six-yard pickup makes for a second and four. Jets lead it 7-0. We're in the first quarter from Shea in New York. Nice fake on Hunter. By the right side, but bottled up. Lawrence Pillar, Greg Buttle, combining to make the stop. Jets going over in the first 5 minutes of play with Clark Gaines crawling over from the one to cap off the 65-yard drive. We have 7 minutes and 20 seconds remaining on this first quarter. And the Seahawks now with a third down play. crowd urging the Jets defense on. Second back coming through Hunter, and he's stopped. Al Hunter driven back by John Hennessy, number 63, the inside linebacker on the left. And the Jet defense, which last year was so suspect, as Bob mentioned just a couple of minutes ago, looking tough that time and making the stop.
That play took too long to develop, Marv. When you've got short yardage, you want the ball to get to the line of scrimmage as fast as possible. I think.
All right. There's Thunderfoot Weaver. Herman Weaver back getting set to kick to Bruce Hoffer, who has been very effective. Last year, 6 in the NFL in punt returns. He's averaging just under 10 thus far. Weaver got away a good one when you consider had trouble with the snap. And no return permitted. So Herman Weaver not allowing a return, and the Jets will take over now, deep in their own territory with 6:09 left in the first quarter. And the Jets leading the Seattle Seahawks by the score of 7-0.
Beer.
Yeah, let's have a new Schlitz Light.
There's a new taste in Schlitz Light. The taste of natural ingredients brewed into a Pilsner beer. New Schlitz Light. Still less filling with a taste that's bigger than light.
Think we won?
Well, it's not whether you win or lose.
It's the beer you choose.
Schlitz Light. Natural Pilsner beer.
When you want to cut out quick, our brand's the one to pick.
You can trust AC.
Thanks, AC.
Sparkplugs by AC.
We help you pick up speed, and speed is what you need.
You can trust AC.
Thanks, AC.
Sparkplugs by AC.
So when you want to go, we're the name to know.
You can trust AC.
Sparkplugs
by AC.
Thanks, AC.
Next Saturday, it's down to the wire action as the surging Yankees try to knock off the Indians and the Bucks battle the Expos. Check local listings for the game in your area.
This is Marv Albert with Bob Crumpy from Shea Stadium in New York. Jets leading Seattle 7-0. Jets now first down at their 13-yard line. Running backs are jerking and long. The quarterback is Todd as Long tries the right side and picks up short yardage on the play. Kevin Long, a seventh-round draft pick a year ago, the ball carrier. Well, the New York Giants out in front of the wing T formation. Kansas City Chiefs 7-0 in the first quarter. And Pittsburgh doing a job on your old ball club, the 0-2 Cincinnati Bengals.
Soon
Would
to
you
be
explain
oh,
that?
No, soon to be 0-3. Well, Ken Anderson's out. That has a lot to do with it. Plus, Pittsburgh is a real nemesis for Cincinnati.
Second and 7 at the 16. Again, the give for Long. He's got an opening. And Long has picked up a first down. The free safety, number 44, John Harris, making the stop on Long.
Well, this is a good play. See the guard pulling out there, opens up a good hole. That's a rather lanky running back, Mr. Long, but he shows me good mobility. That's a nice pickup. The Jets do an awful lot of things good.
A 10-yard advance for Long and a first down for the Jets at their 27-yard line. That's Gaffney to the right and Walker left. On the play action, Todd with time, and it is completed to Wesley Walker, a diving catch made by Walker. And another first down for the Jets. Steve Brown covering on the play.
Well, you see what happens. You talk about one receiver and you try to double cover him. This is just Walker coming over the middle. Todd has a lot of time to throw the ball, and he is a very high percentage passer, and that's a fine catch, a prone position catch. Derek Gaffney. Interesting story about him. He recruited Wes Chandler to Florida, and Wes Chandler took his spot.
He has been playing in the shadow of Wes Chandler right throughout his collegiate career and has really emerged here in his rookie season. Well, Durfee not able to hold on, it's ruled incomplete. Scott Durkin looking to take that swing. So it will be a second and 10 now at the 48-yard line. Richard Todd coming into today, 31 for 51, 60%, six touchdowns, and has been intercepted only three times.
You see him talking to his running back there. That's the kind of leadership you want from your quarterback in the huddle. Hey, look, that's all right. You missed that one. We'll get another one. Don't let it bother you. That's what you need from your quarterback.
Todd now has a second and 10. 4 minutes left, 3, first 13. Quarter. Gets seven. Seahawks nothing. 3, Todd to throw, and he goes the middle, and it is completed for Jeffrey. Jeffrey with a long gainer down near the 16-yard line. Brought down by the left cornerback, Cornell Webster.
Well, you see now with the chuck rule, where you can only hit the guy once in 5 yards, and then you can't touch him the rest of the way down the field. Guys with good speed like Derek Gaffney, there's no way these defensive backs can cover him. He's wide open, even though there's a guy about 5 yards away from him. And Todd will throw it like that all day long to any one of his three receivers, Walker, Gaffney, or Jerome Barkham down the middle.
Derek Gaffney picking up 34 yards on that combination. And the Jets have a first down at the 16-yard line. Evan Long getting the call with Keith Butler, the rookie out of Memphis State, drawing the start today, combining with Dennis Boyd to make the stop. Getting back to Gaffney, Bob, he was an eighth-round draft pick out of the University of Florida, and I think he has surprised even the Jets. They did not think he would come this far.
Absolutely. But a tremendous receiver, and goes well with Walker.
Second and seven at the Seattle 13-yard line. All right, Todd has a deflected and intercepted. Let's see, did he hold on? Yes, he did. An interception for the Seahawks. It is only their second of the season. It's Sammy Green, number 56, coming away with that deflected pass. Sammy Green, a three-year pro out of the University of Florida, picking it off. The Seahawks take over. There's a timeout. We'll be back after these words.
If you wanted to protect the things you own from the risks of this risky world, you'd want a whole army. This is the Continental Army. Its mission is to protect you, your home, your business, and your car against loss. Anywhere, anytime. If you want that kind of protection, call up the Continental, because nobody spells protection like the Continental Insurance Company.
Sudden infant death syndrome, or crib death, is the number one killer of infants after the first month of life. At present, it can neither be predicted nor prevented. Yet when it happens, parents are faced with a tremendous burden of grief and guilt and should be treated with understanding. If you know a family who has lost a child to the sudden infant death syndrome, reach out to them. They need your sympathy and support.
Love is in the air.
You look beautiful.
But so is trouble.
She's blind, too.
On Little House on the Prairie, Monday.
Back at Shea Stadium, Wesley Walker, the intended receiver on this play, fell down. Todd moved a little bit. It was tipped by a defensive lineman, and Sammy Green comes up with it. Seattle's second interception of 1978. And now we go to Seattle's multiple offense.
Richard Todd now 7 for 9, 105 yards. And the fourth time he has been intercepted. McCullum to the right, Largent left. First down for Zorn at the Seattle 12-yard line. The handoff for Testiner. And tried to follow his blocker, but could not. Got lost in the crowd. Don Testiner, who had a strong game against the Jets last year in that 17-0 victory, rushing for 65 yards. Stopped by the combination of Abdul Salam and Joe Klecko.
Second and eight,
2-yard pickup. What a game Klecko had last week. His man, Ken Jones of Buffalo, was called for holding four times. That's incredible.
Yeah. A question to watch, something to watch here. This is the first 34 defense that the Seattle Seahawks have faced this year. Wonder how they play.
All right, second and eight, and Zorn pops one and completes the sideline pass to Sam McCullum, number 84.
Greg Buttle almost got his hand on this one. You'll see him, number 51, you'll see him drop straight back, trying to get in the passing lane. Almost gets it, and a fine catch by McCollum to keep his speed in. A veteran receiver from Minnesota. He'll help this team a lot. Good, consistent receiver.
And he picked up 7 on the play. It'll be a 3rd and 1 for the Seahawks at the 21. Double tight end alignment now for Seattle. Ron Howard and John Sawyer are the tight end. Testament and Sims, the running backs. Whoops. All right, a flag down. And let's see.
The clock says 6. That's what Zorn's arguing. You got 30 seconds to get the playoff in professional football, and the time clock says 6. So they're going to give him another play. Will they give him 30 seconds again?
Yes, they will.
Well, I like that. The official makes a mistake. Okay, let's start all over. Art, that's our fault.
May have picked up on the sidelines. One of the officials says it's a do-over. I thought they only have do-overs in the streets of New York. They called a delay of game, but it was not so. So they'll try again. It is a 3rd and 1. And the handoff for Sims, close to a first down, but will have to wait as Lawrence Pillars was there to make the stop on number 35, David Sims. Seattle players are saying, yes, we made it. Yes, they did. It is a first down for Seattle.
That was right over Steve August, their number one draft choice 2 years ago. Last year, Seattle was not very happy with Mr. August. Norm Evans started in his place. August was hurt, and he was a questionable draft choice in 1976, but has come on to play fine football for him, and they're counting very heavily on him. He's from Tulsa also.
First down for Seattle at their 23. Largent goes left and McCollum right. And Hunter line up in the eye behind Sims. Nice play action by Zorn. He goes sideline. Beautiful move hitting McCollum as he is hit out by Greg Buttle.
I'll tell you what makes this play go, and it shows the veteran receiver, Sam McCollum, he comes back for the ball. If Zorn had thrown it right where he made the break, Greg Buttle would have intercepted it. But as you play professional football, after a while, you realize that you got to come back to the quarterback for a reception. And Sam McCollum did that, and they're going to measure for a first down.
Very close. McCollum tried to pick it up. He's checking out the marker on the sideline as he watched the ball thrown by Zorn. And it is a first down. So McCollum just did
first down,
it.
Seattle.
Coach Jack Patera, the Seattle Seahawks. Seahawks with a record of 5-9 last year. The most successful second-year franchise in the NFL.
Looking desperately for a defense. But I'll tell you, Seattle likes their football team. Here's a statistic for you. The first year of the franchise, 1976, they sold 59,000 season tickets in 27 days. Now they sold 50,000 this year, and they average about 62 per game in the Kingdom. Excellent, growing franchise.
And Seattle to meet the Detroit Lions at home at the Kingdom next Sunday. Seahawks first down at their 32. A handoff for Sims, and just a couple. Mike Kettigan, the inside linebacker, making the stop on David Sims, a two-year pro out of Georgia Tech. Sherman Smith is out, as we mentioned earlier. Suffered a shoulder injury in the opening game against San Diego after scoring a touchdown, a ball game that we telecast. And of course, they missed Sherman Smith, and Patera going with combinations of Hunter, who missed the entire preseason because of injury, and Sims and Testament, and the rookie Rufus Crawford. 2nd and 9 at the 34. Al Hunter is back in now. There's a penalty marker down as the running back moved with Hunter taking the handoff. Sims went too quickly. Salam and Pillars combined to make the stop. Here's the penalty upcoming from Gordon McCarter.
Well, I suppose if you're going to have a penalty, you want it with your player going forward. And he was just a little bit anxious there. There's nothing wrong with that. These are two very youthful football teams. They've got a long time yet to be in the NFL. There's the penalty. Illegal procedure, I believe.
We apologize. The microphone on the field.
Illegal motion.
Not operating.
It's declined.
As McCarter indicated, the illegal motion, penalty declined, so it is a 3rd and 9 now for Seattle. Hawks go with 3 wide receivers, McCullum, Ferguson, and Larkin, for this passing situation. To the Jet 40-yard line, met there by the linebacker who took a deep breath, Greg Little.
Well, as I said, these are two very multiple offenses. They'll do anything to get the ball down the field as the first quarter ends.
So at the end of one, with the Seattle Seahawks on the move, the New York Jets lead the Seahawks 7-0. We'll be back with the second quarter of today's game after these messages from your local station.
Monday, Marsha Mason and Anthony Hopkins in Audrey Rose.
Dumber the Child!
A chilling drama of reincarnation. Then on Tuesday, Airport 77, Jack Lemmon heads an all-star cast. A 747 crashes into the Bermuda Triangle. Can they be saved? 2 blockbusters starting at 9, 8 Central and Mountain.
Out of each sales dollar Chevron took in last year, after expenses, less than 4¾ cents profit was left. Profits are the staff of life which fortify us to meet growing challenges. Part of that profit goes back to Chevron shareholders. The search for new oil takes a slice. Other pieces go for new equipment, refineries, and more. Chevron makes that staff of life go a long way by putting profits back to work. That's the Chevron way.
You're watching KING-TV, Seattle.
Back at Shea Stadium in New York, Marv Albert and Bob Crumpy as we get set for the second quarter. And the Jets leading it by the score of 7-0 with the Seahawks on the move. And Al Hunter, the receiver, holding down that drawn pass inside the 20. And again, it's Buttle making the start. Buttle and Jackson combining. As Zorn has now hit 6 out of 6.
Heading towards a record of 17. And who is that held by? Burt Jones. Very active quarterback. You see Hunter out of the backfield. I'm telling you, they'll throw it to everybody but the head coach. And if he can get open, they'll probably throw it to him. And the New York Jet defensive backfield will be tested severely today.
Now, that has been a major question mark on this ball club. Hunter with a 21-yard pass play. First down at the 19-yard line. And here's Sean throwing on the run. And a diving pass made by Rogers. Spectacular play by Rogers coming back away from Ed Taylor. And it is another first down for Seattle.
Okay, if Jim Zorn has one problem, he's not very tall. But the offensive coaches of Seattle said, okay, well, set up a moving pocket so he can see around and through those defensive linemen. Once again, his favorite receiver, Steve Largent, comes back with his football. Fine throw and comes back for the football. See there? Excellent, excellent. Great combination. Zorn and Largent, they're going to be throwing it and catching it for a lot of years for Seattle.
Zorn now 7 for 7. The Seahawks first and goal at the 8-yard line. They are trailing 7-0. And again, Zorn throwing on the move. Incomplete. Penalty marker. But a penalty marker down. Bobby Jackson covering on the play. But a flag is down. Flag down with Greg Buttle screaming about the call.
Yeah, that'll be number one. The first flag will be roughing the passer. The second one will be unsportsmanlike conduct. And you don't want to do that when you're in there. You want to control. You want to control your emotions. As we talk about it here. All right, well, we'll see Buttle on the blitz. Just trying to contain Jim Zorn. He throws it. Well, he slapped him right in the face, and they probably should have put 20 yards on it. And I'm not so sure they shouldn't throw him out of the game. That's a totally exposed football player. Now, you don't want to hurt somebody like the quarterback of the other team. You want to play a good, honest football game. And especially with the concern of brutality in football, that's uncalled for. He's a good enough football player that he doesn't have to make a reputation of slapping quarterbacks in the face. I'll get off the podium now.
Yeah. All right, here is Gort McConnell.
Greg Buttle
with the personal foul.
The first one was roughing the passer. The second one is unsportsmanlike conduct. That's a penalty of half the distance to the goal.
And it makes for a first and goal from the four. Greg Robinson has come on now as the Jets go to a 4-3 alignment. And Thorne pitching for six, looking to get in. He drives forward and he's in for the score. Steven Sims putting the Seahawks on the board off the shovel from Zorn, and the Seahawks now trail 7-6.
That's a triple option play. I'm surprised they take a chance with Jim Zorn, as valuable he is as the football team, but you watch him option off the outside man on the defense, Buttle. If he goes for the running back, Zorn will keep it. As it turned out, he went for the quarterback, so he gives it to Sims and he scores. I like it.
And now Efren Herrera will attempt the extra point. Zorn holding. Herrera is 3-for-4 in points after thus far this year. And Herrera has tied it up at 7. So 2 minutes in, second quarter, here at Bay Stadium in New York. The New York Jets and the Seattle Seahawks are tied at 7.
Some of the most beautiful homes in the world are down there, and I designed a lot of them.
Natural-looking woods are a favorite of mine. To bring out their full beauty, I always specify Benjamin Moore's Moorwood Stain.
For quality, durability, and color selection, Moorwood Stains are outstanding. If you want a natural look for your home, try Moorwood.
See your Benjamin Moore dealer. He really knows his paint, and stains, too.
Why is America taking to Plymouth Horizon?
It's front-wheel drive. Going around curves is beautiful.
It's a hatchback. With the back seat down, it's like a mini station wagon.
We just returned from a 2 weeks vacation of about 3,000 miles. The handling was tops and the ride was excellent.
Room, comfort, handling.
Plymouth Horizon can handle it.
No wonder Motor Trend magazine calls it Car of the Year.
NBC Sports bringing it all to you from Shea Stadium on a beautiful day, temperature in the 70s, and just a slight breeze, which is most unusual for Shea. Usually the quarterbacks have to battle the wind here. Herrera to kick off to Harper and Stevens. We're tied at 7. 10th play drive, 88 yards with a minute 41. One of the upmen for the New York Jets is Clark Gaines picking up that short kick. And getting back to the 30-yard line. Gaines covered up by Sammy Green. Well, the Bengals on the board, Bob. 14-3 now. Steelers in front.
That doesn't help, though. And the Giants lead Kansas City in the wing tee 14-0.
Atlanta over Cleveland. That's a good matchup, that ball game. Both clubs off to excellent starts. Long and Durkin for running backs. First down at the 29. As the Jets take over, both quarterbacks have done extremely well, although Todd has been intercepted one time. And Todd hits long, penalty marker thrown down. It is only a 5-yard advance if the play holds up, as Sammy Green was right there to stop long. Holding call against the Jets. So the Jets are called for a hold. That Jet offensive line with Chris Ward, this year's number one draft pick. Marvin Powell, last year's number one at the tackles. Randy Rasmussen, Dan Alexander at the guards. Joe Fields,
the center. The tight end is Jerome Barkham. The wide receivers, the sensational duo of Wesley Walker and Derek Gaffney.
Well, let's see if we can pick up who the holding was on. On Rasmussen, the veteran, the only guy left on the Jets from the Super Bowl victory in 1969. Shame on you, Randy.
And it makes for a first and 20. Back at the 19-yard line. Here's Todd with time. He goes short, and he's got long. Long to the 28-yard line. Green and Webster combined to make the stop. So Kevin Long, the second-year man out of South Carolina, seeing a lot of action both as a runner and a receiver here in the first half.
It appears now that Seattle has gone to a total zone situation, and therefore Todd will throw to his running backs a great deal, and he has excellent receiving running backs, Long, Dierking, all of them. So they're not going to be hurt by this total zone defense.
And Bobby has now inserted Bruce Hopper in the backfield, who usually comes in passing situations, second and 11 at the 28. And Todd to throw. Hopper fell down as he went out to the flat, and Todd is in trouble. He is able to get it away and just throws it away. Cornell Webster making the grab out of bounds. Wesley Walker, the intended receiver.
Well, I'm a little surprised at the Jet receivers. When your quarterback is flush from the pocket, you want to run the same direction that he's running. You want to run to the sideline. Anybody standing on the sideline, that the direction the quarterback's running should go upfield. And in that way, the quarterback's got somebody to throw to. I didn't see anybody going that way. Something I got to work on.
Third and 11 now. The Jets up there, 28. We're tied at 7. And 12 minutes remaining in this first half. Richard Todd, three-year pro out of Alabama. All right, this time it is Long with great balance near the first down marker. Kevin Long likes to run low. It looks like he's going to stumble and go down, but he does not. Dave Brown and Keith Butler make the stop close to a first down.
And he's 6 feet, 1 inch tall, so he has to bend Crouch way down to get there. With the way that the Jets throw the ball, this is an excellent play. It was a little trap, draw trap, and Long squirts up through there, shedding tacklers, good strength, good balance. I don't think he got it. Whoa, that just shows you how much I know. First and 10, New York.
Just did pick it up.
It was close.
Well, Bob, from the angle you're at, you know, I let the folks know you're not exactly
my armchair
lined up.
That's right. My armchair is very comfortable here.
It is a first down at the 39-yard line. Scott Dierking back in. Ian Long, the running backs. The handoff for Dierking, following Alexander, trying to cut back the other way, and just picks up a yard. That's all.
Number 25, Scott Dierking.
Dierking stopped by Boyd and Butler. Hi there. Who is that fella? Big guy to the right here.
I'm the football player.
I don't think anybody could tell that, though, Bob.
I'm the one with the bubblegum card on my back. Here we go.
Second and 9 at the 40. Crumpy and intimidating force even in the booth. All right, Todd again with time and through in a crowd. Let's see who came up with the football. Scott Dierking trying to wrestle away two Seattle Seahawks. Keith Butler, 53, and Terry Beeson, number 58, and it is Dierking who came up with it.
That's a fine reception. Once again, I repeat to you, anybody catching a football in professional football, you got to come back towards the quarterback to catch it. If he hadn't come back here, that's an interception. Fine reception. Excellent. That's good for 8 yards.
It makes for a third and 2 at the 48. Jets and Seahawks tied at 7. Three tight ends in for the Jets. Barkham with the rookie Shuler and the second-year pro Reba. And it's Todd on the option and looks to be stopped short of the first down. Cornell Webster making the stop. That was out of the Bear Bryant Alabama playbook.
Absolutely. That's the same play that Seattle scored on down at the other end, too, the triple option. Well, you know, Todd's a durable-type quarterback. He's only had a little bit of injury with his knee, He has the arm of Joe Namath. He does not have the legs, which is a plus for the Jets. And Seattle played that very well. Cornell Webster did. I like that.
All right, Chuck Ramsey. There's John Harris, number 44, awaiting this Ramsey punt. Ramsey was a questionable today because of a pulled muscle. Off to a terrific start after a poor season last year. Ramsey averaging 45 yards per punt. Big rush, nearly blocked. And he got away a good one. Tremendous coverage by the Jets.
I like it. First of all, they almost blocked it. Seattle did it. It always seems to happen that way when it's almost blocked. Bobby Jones got right down there, ran right by the blocker. Harris should have fair caught this. Good hit. Well, he dropped it. It wasn't from the hit. And then he keeps his senses and grabs a hold of the ball. First and 10 Jets. On about the, what is it, the 14-yard line. Whoa, here we go.
Bob Jones, 23-year-old rookie free agent, with a big turnover. First down at the Seattle 13. We're tied at 7. The handoff for long, big opening, and he brings to the 7-yard line. Dennis Boyd, the left defensive tackle, making the stop on Kevin Long. Getting back to Bobby Jones, he attended college at Youngstown State, did not finish, did not play college football, was working as an automobile mechanic in Ohio when he asked the Jets for a tryout. That's a similar story to yours, Bob.
Oh, not quite that. Joe Klecko is another guy that's a mechanic, isn't he?
Yep. Second and 4. And here's Durkin to the 5-yard line. Straight ahead move by Scott Durkin. Keith Butler, rookie linebacker, making the stop on the play. And it will be a 3rd and 2 now for the Jets. 8:20 remaining in this first half. This advertised as a matchup of two of the fine young quarterbacks in the NFL, Richard Todd and Jim Zorn, and we have not been disappointed. A triple tight end alignment now for the Jets. Durkin and Gaines are in the backfield. And the handoff for Gaines.
Untouched. Once again, they went over Chris Ward, their number one draft choice this year. And Shuler, the young tight end over there, got a lot of confidence in that side of the line. That's also the same side of the line that Randy Rasmussen plays on. Clark Gaines goes absolutely untouched into the end zone. Look at Rasmussen, number 66, pulling out there looking for somebody to block. Finally finds somebody 2 yards from the goal line. It is 13-7 to Jets.
Just set up by that Bobby Jones hit on Harris, making for the fumble recovery. Pat Leahy now to try for the extra point. And Leahy on the season is now 8-for-8 as the New York Jets have jumped in front of the Seattle Seahawks by the score of 14-7. We'll be back in just a moment.
You want to buy some radios, but tires all look the same. You've got to have good feelings. Trust the name. No matter where you're going, remember what we said. When Sears is behind you, you come out ahead.
Just an ache. You know, it's like just a constant aching.
Thaddeus Golas has a headache.
You're probably not really operating at full potential when you have a headache.
Will you try extra strength Tylenol?
Sure.
Compare regular aspirin, the leading extra ingredient pain reliever, and extra strength Tylenol. Extra strength Tylenol has more medicine.
I feel relieved. I feel good.
What pain reliever would you take next time?
Extra strength Tylenol, I'm sure.
Extra strength Tylenol. It's aspirin free, and you can't buy a more potent pain reliever without a prescription.
See live regional coverage of hard-hitting NFL football action starting with NFL 78 next Sunday on NBC. Check local listings for the game in your area.
Well, the Jets doing it in 3 plays, going 13 yards following the hit and fumble recovery by Bobby Jones. This is Rufus Crawford on the kickoff return.
Pretty low by Crawford as he gets it out across the 30-yard line. Rufus Crawford, who averaged 26 yards per return during the preseason, a rookie out of Virginia State, an impressive run back. He was stopped by backup safety man Kenny Strong. Incidentally, with Gaines going over on that touchdown, the Jets, who came into today without a touchdown rushing, now have both their scores on the ground.
And all we talked about was passing, right? Well, they'll get one.
And Gaines with both scores. Seahawks trailing 14-7, first down at their 31-yard line. Launching in the slot left. This is Sims. Sims with acceleration out to the 37-yard line. Lawrence Pillars makes the stop on number 35, David Sims. Sims had a quiet day last week against Pittsburgh, carried nine times for 20 yards. He's averaging about three per pop. Second and about three. Here is Largent coming out, bottom of your screen. Sims and Hunter are the running backs. And a give again for Sims, and he has stopped short of a first down. He's shy about a yard. Salam and Klecko combining.
Klecko. Joe Klecko. There's another guy that, as I said earlier, is a mechanic. And when I think it's fashionable for professional football players to carry leather bags and wear leather coats, Joe Klecko drives a 69 Volkswagen. Or can I say that? I can say that. A 69 Volkswagen. And is a great ping pong player. And is a certified mechanic for a major oil company. So, I mean, talk about planning for the future. When he can no longer get to the passer, he can always fix your radiator.
Are you doing some PR work for Mr. Klecko also?
No. I like it. You know, most guys that make professional football are high school All-Americans, college All-Americans. They get their picture on the front of Time and Sports Illustrated. There's a guy who comes up the hard way, and that's the way I came up. That's why I appreciate those guys.
They said Klecko was too small also at 6'3", 256. Third and about a half yard to go. And Sims able to stutter his way through. And able to pick a hole to get the first down. David Sims stopped by Taylor and Owens. And it's a first down for Seattle.
And we talked about Klecko. They just ran right over him. So maybe he's good at getting to the passer, but a little suspect when it comes to the run. You know anything about that?
I believe you have hit it right on the head from what I've seen the New York Jets.
That happens. See, they're double-teaming Klecko, though. Let's give him a little credit. It's tough to stop 500 pounds worth of tackle at fullback.
I don't know, Bob. You set him up beautifully. Now you're slamming him.
Go get him, Joe.
All right, first and 10 now. Off the play action. Here is Zorn looking for Hunter. And he's got it over the jump. Hunter with the first down as Hennigan tipped it. And a penalty marker thrown down as Hunter picks up the extra yard. And John Hennessy covering up on Al Hunter.
Good play action by Seattle, and that flag should have been thrown. That was a late hit. Once again, we talk about the brutality in football. There's no reason to do that. He got beat. He was trying to get back at the guy. Use your head out there, Mr. Hennigan, for something other than a weapon. I don't like this. He played it well. He tips it up in the air. This is uncalled for. You'll see how flagrant a violation this is, and then he complains, which makes he's down. That's awful. That's terrible. That's not football. That isn't the way the game was designed to be played, nor is that the use for which that helmet was made. And that's uncalled for.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 52, defense.
With a little feedback, we have
If I may tell you something just as an ex-player, I think that any time that you have an unsportsmanlike conduct or unnecessary roughness, there should be a monetary fine go with it. Keep the guy in the game, but fine him, and I think that'll stop it.
All right, off the penalty, first down at the 16-yard line. Zorn is now 8-for-8. This is Hunter on a sweep and cuts back the other way. Nice move by Hunter, but a penalty marker down once again. Hunter getting down to the 10-yard line. Joe Klecko making the stop.
Off by number 23.
it's a hold this time against Seattle.
And that flag traveled about 40 yards in the air. Maybe that official that threw it could play some football. I think it was on a wide receiver. I'll make that guess. They'll take the penalty. All the discussion there is where it's going to be exactly, but I'm sure they'll put him back 15 yards.
Gordon McConner talking it over with Burgess Owens.
But you know, the thing is, you give a penalty to Seattle or New York, you come up with first down and 20, 25. It really doesn't hurt either one of these teams because you try to get half of it back. You don't go for the entire yardage. And so you end up second and 12, complete another pass, you end up third and four.
Hopefully, number 87, offense, first down.
That's a tight end. Uh-oh. They're always open and they always hold, I guess. That's not true.
Bob, speak for yourself. Ron Howard, the tight end. The man who has been penalized, and it's a first and 20 back at the 26-yard line. And here is Zorn, who is 8-for-8. Make it 9-for-9 off the diving catch by McCullum. Bobby Jackson, the left cornerback.
Well, they're taking advantage of the backside of the zone defense by the Jets. Now, what they're doing is rotating one way or another as we watch his ninth consecutive pass completion. And they're throwing it to the backside of the zone, and they're throwing it past the linebacker. The linebacker is responsible for that area. He's supposed to stop that.
Second and 9 as John Yarno leads the Seahawks to the line. That's Ferguson out to the right and Largent left. And Zorn trying for 10 in a row, and he does not get it. Largent, the intended receiver, and finally the Zorn streak is stopped as Ed Taylor, number 38, the right cornerback, broke it up.
He's disgusted. He threw that behind Largent. That was a bad pass, but it's the first one he's thrown so far. Good pressure by the Jets defense, though, helped him, made him rush that one just a little bit. Big play coming here, Marv.
It is a 3rd and 9. Jets leading the Seahawks 14-7. Just under 5 minutes left in this first half. Now Steve Rabel has come on. Extra receivers being employed by Jack Patera for this 3rd down passing situation. He fooled him as Sims, the ball carrier, got the first down and more, driving toward the goal line. A gorgeous fake with Jets looking for the pass. Sims on the first, right the right side, and it's a first and goal now for Seattle. Suggs and Owens just did get to Sims.
What did I tell you about this multiple offense of Seattle? They'll do anything to get the ball down the field. This is a fine, fine fake by Jim Zorn. Look, I like that. And Sims gets out ahead of his offensive lineman here, number 61, and still makes all that yardage. It is first and goal, Seattle.
And number 61, the left guard, Tom Lynch, running alongside, clearing the way for David Sims. From the 2-yard line, first and goal. Beautiful fake again, and Sims brings it home. The fake was to Hunter, and it was Sims going to the left side, and the Seahawks now trail it 14-13. Beautifully handled drive by the quarterback, Jim Zorn.
That was a sucker play. They pulled the offensive lineman right in front of that defensive tackle, and you'll see the defensive lineman goes with the guard. There is nobody there. Nobody there. Greg Robinson pulled out of there. Oh, that fine play for the score.
Zorn holding now for Herrera. Will look to tie it. And he does. 4 minutes and 1 second left in this first half. And the Seattle Seahawks and the New York Jets are now tied at 14. And we'll be back right after these words.
Look through the camera of Gene Paluso, contributing photographer Vogue magazine. You'll see some totally new views of the 1978 Chrysler Cordoba.
To me, Cordoba is elegance. I just love the way it looks. It's a beautiful, exciting, comfortable car. The lines are simple, clean. It's understated. Nothing is overdone. Look at Cordoba. Very fashionable.
Chrysler Cordoba for 1978. Now, put yourself in the picture.
We'll be right back.
for me.
New Schlitz Light.
There's a new taste in Schlitz Light. The taste of natural ingredients brewed into a Pilsner beer. New Schlitz Light. Still less filling with a taste that's bigger than light.
Gentlemen, here's to fast horses.
Schlitz Light and those who love them.
Schlitz Light. Natural Pilsner beer.
Disney's 25th year celebration continues with the enchanting story of Dumbo, plus highlights from Pinocchio and Snow White. Dumbo, Sunday at 7, 6 Central.
Right here, we pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC Television Network.
You're watching Channel 5, KING-TV, Seattle.
The bounding kickoff picked up by Bruce Harper, and Harper brings back across the 30-yard line.
I've been waiting for Bruce Harper to do something. I got something for you ladies. This young man went to school with John Travolta in New Jersey. I didn't see him in Saturday Night Live, but they call him the Smidget. That's a small midget, but he can play. And, of course, he knows John Travolta, so certainly doesn't have to look too far for employment. The Smidget.
The Smidget from Kutztown State.
Kutztown State. That's where Walt Michaels' son goes.
That's right.
Where is Kutztown State?
And upon his recommendation, Bruce is with the ball club. Doug Dennison of the Dallas Cowboys.
True.
Same alma mater. This is Kevin Long, who is stacked up. Peter Conan, number 57, a second-year pro at Boston College, making the stop on Long. That time, Long ran high as he tried to elude Cronin, but could not.
The Seahawks have an excellent linebacker core. Green, Beeson, and Cronin. Those three young guys are going to play an awful lot of football for these Seahawks. Beeson led the team in tackles the last 2 years. Was a very high draft choice and also part of the Tony Dorsett deal. They got four players to start for him. Dallas got Dorsett.
Second and nine now for Richard Todd.
Steve.
And he is gone.
What did we say in a pregame show? They'll send him deep about 6-8 times a game and try to get it to him. This ball was underthrown, or Walker would have scored. Ah, there's Todd. I like that. The field general. But he sets up there and throws it deep, and Wesley Walker, who averaged 21 yards plus per catch last year. Fine reception, too. The guy's got his hand in his face. Still makes the catch. Excellent reception. He's got something wrong with him. He doesn't concentrate on the ball enough on the short pass.
Picked up 49 yards. First down for the Jets at the 19. This is Long to the outside. Kevin Long. Stopped by the free safety, John Harris. Rasmussen and Ward leading the way for Long, who cut to the outside. And Long brings inside the 10-yard line.
I repeat to you this statistic. As we are now in the two-minute warning, but the Jets were the 26th worst defense in the NFL last year. The Seahawks, 27th. Lots of scoring today.
Well, the Jets with a second and one upcoming when we resume. Following this two-minute warning, it's a tie ball game at 14.
Are we going to be the Bowman Jets tonight?
Yeah!
Are we having a problem?
Yeah.
Did I forget my press stone?
Yeah.
Take out the old, put in the two. Put in the Prestone, Prestone 2.
Protect against freeze-ups and corrosion. Take out old, weak antifreeze and put in America's most trusted antifreeze, Prestone 2.
Take out the old, put in the 2. Put in the Prestone, Prestone 2.
And when you flush your cooling system, use Prestone Super Flush.
Here's the new Pennzoil that saves gasoline. And Kenny Stabler, quarterback of the Oakland Raiders. New Pennzoil PZL. The Pennzoil that saves gasoline.
That's right. You know the Pennzoil in this can? It really does help you go farther on a gallon of gasoline. And it saves you oil changes, too. They call it Pennzoil PZL. I call it a winner.
Next Saturday, it's down-to-the-wire action as the surging Yankees try to knock off the Indians and the Bucks battle the Expos. Check local listings for the game in your area.
Well, to
last segment of the near-capacity crowd here at Shea Stadium. What a day it is for New York sports. The Giants and Kansas City before a sellout at Giants Stadium. Red Sox and Yankees, sellout crowd Yankee Stadium. Might be a sellout here, perhaps just short. Second and one now from the 9-yard line, and Kevin Long is stopped back behind by Keith Butler. So the rookie linebacker, second-round draft pick number 53, Keith Butler, shooting right through to stop Long.
And this is rather unusual, I think, in that the Seattle's first-round draft choice this year was a guy named Keith Simpson from Memphis State. Their second-round draft choice, a guy named Keith Butler from Memphis State. This is his first start as a pro. Go get him, kid.
Well, that time he stopped Long, making for a third and three now, back at the 11. High ball game at 14. Less than two to go, first half. And Todd to go to the air. A penalty marker down. Touchdown for Barkham. But let's see what the flag is all about. Jerome Barkham, if it counts, has come up with his third score of the season. It will not count. A holding penalty against the Jets. Flag went down as Todd was making his move, fading back.
Jerome Barkham is not a very big tight end. And that's really kind of the fashion nowadays, I think, of professional football, especially when you got a guy like Richard Todd throwing it, you want a receiving tight end. And he played wide receiver.
Holding, number 60, offense, third down.
Gordon McCarter sounding better and better. Dan Alexander, the man who did the holding, number 60.
I don't know if we're going to be able to see this or not, but Richard Todd's got an awful lot of time to throw. Maybe that's why. And as I said about Jerome Barkham, an excellent receiver, played wide receiver for the Jets for 5 or 6 years. A real plus for this football team.
And it's now a third and 13 back at the 21. And Todd goes for the end zone again. Dave Brown, the late quarterback, picking it off. And that's the second interception of the day off Richard Todd. Wesley Walker, the intended receiver, and Todd threw it short.
Now, one of the things that a quarterback has to learn when he comes into the NFL is to read defenses. I think Richard Todd misread this defense. The man open in that coverage was Jerome Barkham down the middle. He threw it a little too quickly. I think this is a bad choice on Richard Todd's part. Maybe trying to go a little too much to Wesley Walker.
We have a minute 8 left in the first half. Seahawks take over, and there's a timeout on the field. Tie ball game at 14. We'll be back at Shea in just a moment.
I don't know what it is, but there's something about a Big Mac that keeps me coming back.
You're the one who keeps coming back. There's something about a Big Mac that keeps you coming back. Keeps you coming back. Coming back to that Big Mac.
I'd hypothesize that it is definitely the lettuce.
These are the two all-beef patties, special sauce, lettuce and cheese. All the pickles and onions on a bun. Could it be those sesame seeds?
One thing is the two all-beef patties.
That's two things, Bob.
You're the one who keeps coming back. There's something about a Big Mac that keeps you coming back. Keeps you coming back. Coming back to that Big Mac. No matter where you're going, you keep on coming back. To McDonald's store again for one more Big Mac at McDonald's.
There's nothing without the sesame seeds.
We do it all for you. Coming back to a Big Mac. We do it all for you. Coming back to a Big Mac.
There is Richard Todd on the sideline, and just out of your picture there is George Hitzig going back up the sideline. He's the offensive coordinator, and I'm sure that Mr. Hitzig is telling Richard you misread that defense.
All right, Seattle first and 10 from the 20-yard line as Thorne, with only his second incomplete of the afternoon. He's now 9 for 11. The intended receiver was Steve Rabel. Kennigan covering on the play. A minute 3 left, first half. Seahawks and Jets are tied at 14. Clark Gaines scoring both Jet touchdowns on the ground. And David Sims scoring both Seahawk touchdowns on the ground. Jim Zorn has had a magnificent first half. Second and 10. McCullum is to the left and Largent right. Slot right formation. Zorn off the pump. Underthrow. intended for Rabel, with Buttle covering on the play. So it is now a third and 10.
Well, the Jets are playing a total zone defense here now with 58 seconds left. They're going to lay back as best they possibly can. And in a total defense with a 34 up front, you've got eight guys back there in coverage. So it's very, very difficult. It's very, very difficult to throw the ball down there. And it's not that Zorn doesn't have the experience to throw it. It's just that they got eight guys back there, the Jets do, to stop the pass.
It is a third and 10 as Larkin is now out to the left side, McCullum right. Zorn looking for Larkin. And he's got him. Larkin out to the 35 for a first down. Taylor and Hennigan combining on Steve Larkin.
And the corollary to what I was... Here we go with the quick offense. I'll tell you in a minute. Let's watch.
40 seconds left in this first half. First down. Just outside the 35, and a timeout is called by Seattle.
Okay, now what I was going to say was, because the Jets are only rushing three defensive linemen, Zorn's going to have a lot of time to throw. Give his chance to, his receivers a chance to get open, and we'll be back.
Get some happiness going. Spread a little cheer. Send the new FTD Wishin' Well Bouquet. It's such a wonderful way to wish folks well, complete with penny for good luck. And your FTD florist can deliver your good wishes almost anywhere. The FTD Wishin' Well Bouquet with a good luck penny. It's very therapeutic. Those FTD florists really get around for you.
We wanted an economy wagon. Everybody said we'd have to give up something, like big car ride or a lot of room.
But what of us?
Well, we didn't give up. We got this Plymouth Hilari wagon.
Right!
We got the economy we wanted, but we didn't give up big car ride. We didn't give up room for the kids.
Thanks, Mom.
Don't give up.
Don't give up. For just $47.11, get a Plymouth Hilari wagon.
Don't give up. Get a Hilari.
See live regional coverage of hard-hitting NFL football action starting with NFL 78 next Sunday on NBC. Check local listings for the game in your area.
As you see, 32 seconds remaining in this first half. Seattle has two timeouts remaining. They have the ball first down at the 37-yard line. Tie ball game at 14. And here is Jim Zorn adding to David Sims, getting a couple of blocks and runs it out of bounds to stop the clock short of the first down. Runs out at the 45-yard line. John Hennessy makes the stop.
Okay, now what Seattle's going to try to do here is they're going to try to get as much yardage as they possibly can. But you don't fight for inches in this situation. You got two timeouts. You got to save one of those for your field goal kicker. It'd be very nice if Seattle went in at halftime leading 17-14. So they'll try to throw the ball to the outside. They'll try to run sweeps, and they tell their receivers to get out of bounds. The Jets defenders, on the other hand, are saying, keep them inbound. Watch for the outside passes. We'll see who wins in this confrontation.
All right, second, about 2.5 to go. 27 seconds remaining in the second quarter. All right, Zorn in trouble, and it'll run out of trouble, and he's got the first down. Tries to get out of bounds, but cannot. He tried to stop the clock, and the timeout has been called with 17 seconds remaining. Jim Zorn outrunning the coverage. Some words between Jet and Seahawk players.
How's your family? You know, a good restaurant? Okay, as I said earlier, Jim Zorn, fine block on Hennigan there. And one on Klecko, and I think Joe doesn't like that. And he does make it out of bounds and stop the clock with 17 seconds left. First and 10 at the 50, 35 yards, and they got 3 points for Mr. Efren Herrera, they hope.
First down at midfield. Watch it now goes out to the right side. Off the slot right formation. And Thorn looking sideline. Receiver for tight end Ron Howard, and Bob Martin is come up with his first intercept of the season. And we have 8 seconds left in the first half with the Jets taking over.
I don't think that Ron Howard saw this ball thrown. You see, he looked a little mystified there. But it stops the drive, looking to lateral to somebody. I think maybe if he'd have stepped out of bounds, they might have gotten one more playoff and maybe a field goal for that lady. Well, there he is on the sideline. Yes, sir. That's a fine catch, too. That wasn't an easy one.
That's the man that Walt Michaels calls the most consistent linebacker on the ball club. Separated shoulder, knocked him out of most of last season. Three-year pro out of Nebraska, Bob Martin. Jets now first down at their 48-yard line. Only 8 seconds remaining in this first half. Durkin and Long are the running backs for Richard Todd. And Todd, of course, looking deep. He throws way downfield and intercepted by John Harris. And Harris on the return, looking for blockers and wrestled down out of the 45-yard line. Wesley Walker, the intended receiver, as the gun sounds, ending this first half as Todd is intercepted for the third time this afternoon. So at halftime, the Seahawks of Seattle 14 and the Jets of New York 14. We'll be back with our halftime in just a moment.
From the Sierras to the Smokies, people are discovering what makes the great outdoors great.
Beer makes it good.
It's just one Schlitz.
There's no debate.
Nothing else comes near.
Beer makes it good.
When you're out of Schlitz,
Schlitz makes it great.
You're out of beer.
Nobody makes it like Schlitz. Every drop chill lagered for quality. 11 million times a day, America reaches for a Schlitz. Because since 1849, Schlitz makes it great.
So when it comes to beer, why make it good? Schlitz makes it like no other good. Schlitz makes it great.
My father was in a car accident while I was up at school. He'll be okay, but it'll be about a year before he can go back to work and support the family. So I'm going to work instead. We made such plans for college. But I guess there are some things that you just don't plan on.
Sometimes a man's disability can cripple his entire family. Talk to us at Money about your disability insurance needs. Mutual of New York. Money for the future.
That's my team, the Seattle Seahawks. And I'm Steve Largent. Last year, the Seahawks and our United Way showed you the Pacific Northwest, the Cascade Range, Puget Sound, Seattle, and the Space Needle. This year, I want to show you a special part of our town. We have a fire department here like no other in the country, with a special program to save the lives of people who have heart attacks. When someone has a heart attack, what happens in the next 7 minutes can mean the difference between death and being back to work in a week. Our fire department can get there in 4 minutes, so they've trained 100,000 people what to do before they arrive. It's a good feeling to walk down the streets of Seattle and know that if you had a heart attack, chances are someone could help you. At first, the program was supported by groups like the Rotary and Heart Association. But when they couldn't handle it alone, the fire department asked our United Way to come to the rescue, and they did. The United Way works in Seattle, and it works in your town, too. Thanks to you, it works for all of us, the United Way.
Back at Shea Stadium in New York, Marv Albert with Bob Trumpy, and we are tied at halftime, the Jets and the Seahawks at 14 apiece. And we mentioned right at the start, Bob, that this should be an excellent matchup of two fine young quarterbacks in Jim Zorn of Seattle and Richard Todd of Jets. Zorn started out on fire, hitting his first nine and then threw some incompletions. Todd, I get the idea, has had a very sloppy first half, maybe overconfident about hitting people like Wesley Walker and Derek Gaffney. As a result, he has been intercepted three times,
by the Seahawks.
Yeah, the thing I would question about Richard Todd is his discretion. I mean, that's one of the things that a quarterback has to have. Know when to throw it, when not to throw it. At times, you want to take a sack and not throw the interception. On the other side of the coin, Jim Zorn's looked very, very good. Nine straight, as you said. And he's only really thrown a couple of bad passes the whole afternoon. I look for more of the same in the second half.
All right, recapping the scoring, Clark Gaines, who had lost his starting job to Kevin Long, scored on a one-yard move, and the Jets had a 7-0 lead. David Sims scored from 4 yards out off a pitch out from Zorn, and after Herrera kicked the extra point, we're tied at 7, still first quarter. In the second quarter, midway through, following Bobby Jones on a key play with a hard hit on John Harris on a punt return, Harris fumbled, Jones recovered, gave the Jets a tremendous field position, and Gaines went in from 5 yards out. Leahy kicked the extra point, and the Jets had a 14-7 lead, and with 4 minutes left in the second quarter, David Sims scored on a 2-yard run, and that tied it with Herrera converting the extra point. And that's the way we are at halftime, the Jets and Seattle even at 14.
Well, as we said in the pregame show, we didn't expect to see much defense from either of these teams. I repeated, and it's worth repeating, that last year the Jets were the 26th worst team in defense in the NFL. The Seahawks were 27th. So these two teams have to rely a lot on their offense. And I look for about the same thing. They've got to make some defensive adjustments because the Jets are running the ball very well against Seattle. They got to do something to stop that. But throw the ball a little more and just keep throwing it and cut down on the mistakes by the Jets, and the discretion of Richard Todd really is the story.
Bob, the more I see of Jim Zorn, and you and I did the opening game against San Diego out in Seattle, and we mentioned what Jack Lambert had to say after the Pittsburgh game, that he may be the best quarterback in the NFL. He didn't say best young quarterback. He said best quarterback, which might be stretching it a bit at this point. There's no question he is one of the top quarterbacks in the league. But how do you stop a guy like this, particularly when he's on his passing game? We haven't seen him do that much scrambling, but because of the combination of being a running threat and able to throw that ball, he is a very difficult man to defense against.
You've got to do it with a blitz and a linebacker, and you've got to do it with pass rush. That's what you have to do to stop Jim Zorn. You have to disrupt his timing because he has very good timing with his receivers. And if you can make him think a little bit and wonder if those guys are going to get to him, I mean the pass rushers, then he's not going to be able to throw quite as much. And you also, when you go in to tackle him, if you're a defensive lineman, you go in low because he's very slippery and you got to get him on the ground.
All right, once again, the score at halftime. The New York Jets and the Seattle Seahawks are tied at 14, and we'll be back after these messages from your local station.
Disney's 25th year celebration continues with the enchanting story of Dumbo, shown for the first time in 15 years. Then, the spectacular conclusion of King Kong, the most colossal film adventure of all time. King Kong, as you've never seen him before. Tonight at 9, 8 Central, right after Dumbo on NBC.
When you traveled in my day, you had three ways to pay for your expenses. Gold, sight drafts, or paper currency, none of which is particularly convenient or safe. But today, you folks can get Master Charge or Visa from Seattle First, the first bank in the state to offer both cards. And they're safer than cash, more acceptable than checks, but good as gold all over the world.
For something new in banking, look for it first at Seattle First.
This is Quality Control at Crescent Foods. Hi, I'm Bob Robertson. If you think sports are tough, meet Crescent's food technologists. They're demanding because Crescent's customers are. Like school cafeterias, big hospitals, bakeries, fast food restaurants. When these people prepare food, it's got to be right, just like in your kitchen. Crescent, it's the word for flavor.
Right now, something beautiful is happening at JCPenney. It's the September home sale with great savings on this mellow pecan dining room, on sleek contemporary dinettes, savings on laundry teams, TV sets, stereo systems, on lamps to light up your life, and so much more. We'll make your home the most beautiful place it can be. The September home sale at JCPenney.
You're watching KING-TV, Seattle.
Marv Albert. with Bob Trumpy back at Shea Stadium in New York, where the Jets and the Seahawks are tied at 14. We have the official stats on Jim Zorn. 10 for 14, 137 yards, that one intercept. And Richard Todd, 8 for 14, 171 yards. And he was intercepted three times. Bob, checking the scoreboard. Here's one I'll let you give, all right? Cincinnati on the short, and I hate to do this to you.
Well, my old team is not having very much luck so far this season. They're 0-2, and it looks like they're going to be 0-3 because Pittsburgh leads them 21-3.
And they are in the second quarter. All right, at Giants Stadium, the Giants out in front of the Kansas City Chiefs, 14-7. Ted McKnight just scored for Kansas City from 2 yards out. In the second quarter, Pisacek has thrown 2 touchdowns for the Giants, 1 to Bob Hammond and 1 to Don Perkins. In the second quarter, Chicago in front of Detroit, 7-0 on a 1 yard run by Walter Payton. Cleveland and Atlanta now in the second quarter with 5:45 remaining, and they are tied at 10. Standback going over from 15 to tie it at 10. Houston leading San Francisco 7-0 in the first quarter on a 4 yard run by Earl Campbell. That's his 4th touchdown of the season. He leads the National Football League in points scored. He went in tied with Pat Leahy of the Jets. All right, Tampa Bay out in front of Minnesota 3-0 on a 42 yard field goal by Neil O'Donoghue with 7:56 remaining in the first quarter. So the Minnesota Vikings, who come off that Monday night victory against the Denver Broncos in a controversial situation in the final seconds of that ball game, now find themselves trailing the Tampa Bay Buccaneers by the score of 3-0.
Yeah, I think there are going to be a lot of surprises this year in the NFL. With 16 league games, the Jets lead the Eastern Division of the AFC 2-0. Baltimore appears to be dying on the vine. There's no telling what's going to happen here.
All right, what about right here, Bob? Tied at 14. What do you look for in the second half?
Well, I don't think they can change much. Both of these teams like to throw the ball. I was very impressed with the Jets' first drive. They came out and they just ran it right down the throat. Good combination of pass and catch. Also some good running by Long. And I don't see it changing much. They're not going to change. They're going to stay, make a few minor adjustments in the zones for each defense. And nothing more than that. They get a chance to look at the first half statistics, and they'll go back to their normal stuff.
The only adjustment that I can see, perhaps Richard Todd might be a bit more conservative in terms of going long range with Walker and Gaffney.
Yeah, use his other receivers a little more. Barkham is a good receiver. Gaffney's a good receiver. He may be looking a little too often for Wesley Walker.
Walker, as we said right at the start, would get double coverage, but has not been getting it right throughout. So, as a result, Todd has been looking for Wesley.
Well, if he does get double coverage, I mean, that should be exactly what the Jets want, because he's got two running backs that can catch the ball very well. Barkham and Gaffney are both excellent receivers, so he's just got to put Walker on the shelf for a while and go to these other guys, and then maybe Walker will open up. Although he did have that 49-yard reception that one time he outran the zone.
On the other hand, when you take a look at Jim Zorn and his game, of course, his favorite receiver is Steve Largent, but going into the season, and we talked about it before the game against San Diego, the feeling was he would not go to his tight ends, and he only went to certain people, but it seems that he has opened up his game considerably. In fact, Coach Patera says that he has matured as a quarterback, and that's the main reason he has cut down on interceptions.
And he has matured very quickly and shows great discretion as a quarterback, and he is going to be an excellent one.
Not forcing the issue the way did his first couple of years in the league.
That's right. Waiting for the man to get open. He has confidence in his offensive line to give him time to pass the ball. And, of course, the big plus for him is he's a great scrambler. He can get out of trouble easily. So he's going to be all right.
Okay. We are tied at halftime. The Jets and the Seahawks are even at 14 apiece. And we'll be back with second half action in just a couple of minutes.
This 1978 National Football League game is brought to you by Schlitz. Beer makes it good. Schlitz makes it great. And by your Chrysler Plymouth dealers, where you can add a little life to your style with a new size Chrysler LeBaron.
Secret of my success? Lots of my parts are better than your car's original parts. You know where I get them?
A beauty, isn't it? Were the parts hard to find? Let's say I had a good source.
Where do I get my parts? Who's got over 50 years in the business, besides me?
Who should you see for your auto parts needs? NAPA. We help keep America moving.
Here's the Radio Shack Hi-Fi system sale you've been waiting for. At $270 off our separate items price, this powerful 55-watt receiver, two of these fine speakers, this British-made multi-play turntable, wood cabinets, a lifetime investment in sound entertainment, the sale-priced realistic stereo system, only at Radio Shack, a Tandy company.
Hey, how'd you like some free gasoline when you fill up?
I'd like it a lot.
Change to new Quaker State Sterling Motor Oil.
You're telling me an oil change?
We'll get you better gas mileage. See, Quaker State Sterling is a whole new kind of oil, specially blended to lubricate better than regular oils. Less friction, so your engine will work less hard.
And use less gasoline.
It'll be like getting extra gas for free. Change to new Quaker State Sterling. It's like getting free gas with every tank full.
Just about set for the opening kickoff to get the second half underway. As you look at the halftime statistics, Seahawks out in front, 15 first downs to the Jets, 14.
Marv, I'm not one to really rely a great deal on statistics, but the turnovers down at the bottom of your screen there, two for the Seahawks and three for the Jets. All three of those Jets turnovers were interceptions. And that, I think, is the biggest selling point in this football game so far. With the score tied, those three turnovers by the Jets may prove the difference on at the end of the day.
Two turnovers by Seattle, one on that hard hit by Bobby Jones, the John Harris fumble resulting, leading to a Jet touchdown, and the other is on intercept. As you look at Jet head coach Walt Michaels in his second year as head coach, longtime assistant, and a star linebacker in the NFL over the years with the Cleveland Browns, Jack Patera of Seattle. As we get set for this kickoff from Pat Leahy, Marv Albert and Bob Crumpy from Shea Stadium in New York. And back deep, Rufus Crawford and Duke Ferguson. And Crawford takes it once again, out to the 10. Crawford, looked out at the 15-yard line. Tremendous coverage by the Jets with Larry Keller, backup linebacker, not letting loose as Crawford tried to pull away but could not. Seattle first down at their 15-yard line. And setting the Seahawks, Jim Zorn running the ball club right throughout. Sam McCollum comes left, Steve Largent out to the right side. Al Hunter and David Sims are the running backs as they shift to the regular pro set. Now Hunter back to the eye, lined up behind Sims. And the handoff for Sims. Straight ahead move for short yardage. Stopped by the nose tackle, Abdul Salam. Pillar, Salam, and Fucko up front. Buttle, Hennessy, Hennigan, and Martin are the linebackers. Young Bobby Jackson, only 21 years old. The left cornerback, Ed Taylor on the right side. And Schaefer Suggs and Burgess Owens are the deep man.
If I may make a comment away from the action here, the general manager now of the Jets, Jim Kinsel, came up with a great idea, and that is changing the color of the Jets' helmet, mainly because three other teams in the AFC East have the same color as they used to have, white. Good thinking franchise here.
And the Jets are wearing their home uniforms today, second and seven. And Zorn picks up the first down by hitting Al Hunter. Hennessy and Hennigan combining to make the stop. Over the years, the Jets have been noted as having, hate to use the word ugly, Bob, but noted for not the smartest looking uniforms in the National Football League.
Well, but they were changed for a good purpose, not because everybody thought they were ugly, but Kinsel thought that the quarterback was looking at all those same colored helmets and making them green might help, and I think he's got a point.
All right, first down at the 30 off the play action. Zorn with much time. Now checks it over and dumps it off. The tight end, Ron Howard, who was, as you can tell, not the primary receiver, but Fuddle made the stop on Howard. Zorn with much time, but couldn't find it in.
He showed me something there, Marv. He had two receivers. We had a halfback out of the backfield, Sims, or Hunter, excuse me. He wasn't open, and then he sees his tight end there. That's great discretion. Instead of throwing the ball down there and looking for a receiver that might be open, he looks elsewhere. And you've got to be able to look at your secondary and third receivers to make it in the NFL.
And he picked up 7, 2nd and 3 at the 37. It by himself off the option and a stop, picking up perhaps a yard. Klecko making the tackle.
Well, that was a broken
stop
play
by number 70.
That certainly was not. There's my friend, Mr. Joe Klecko. Jim Zorn just missed the handoff. Evidently, the halfback was too wide there on the handoff or something, but he didn't want to do that, believe me. Now we got the big guys in there. Testament. Short yardage.
3rd and 2. The two tight ends, Ron Howard, John Sawyer, in the lineup. Testament and 6 are the setbacks, and the crowd urging the Jet defense on. Ozone throws as he pulls the Jets, and they've got the first down as Largent picks off that short pop, and that is popped out of bounds by Ed Taylor. First down for the Seahawks.
I don't think there's any way you can stop that play, Marvin. It's a good third down and short yardage play, but that was a fine reception by Steve Largent. Once again, the familiarity between quarterback and receiver. Zorn took 3 quick steps, and he knew that Largent would be there. That's a fine completion for a first down. Multiple offense.
3 minutes gone by, 3rd quarter. Jets and Seahawks tied at 14. First down at the 42 of Seattle. Again, the play action. And Thorne is hit down. Combination of Pillars, number 76, and Klecko, number 73, with the first sack of the afternoon.
Well, that play didn't work from the start. Either he turned the wrong way or the running back ran into him, but he stumbled a little bit there, and it appears that the Jets have made an adjustment in their defense because there was nobody open downfield. Once again, the discretion, though. He didn't throw it. He took the sack. Now he's got 2nd down and about 14 yards. That's easy to get back. He didn't want to throw an interception.
Well, the Jets, not an effective sack ball club, but they got to Zorn for the first time, and it's a 2nd and 14. Is down to the left side. And Zorn throws the middle. He's got Ferguson. Ferguson short of a first down by some 7 yards out of the 46-yard line. Inside linebacker Mike Hennigan, number 52, first to Ferguson with help from Bob Martin.
Once again, talking away from the game here a little bit. Duke Ferguson, I think, is the guy that finally swung the deal with Tony Dorsett and the 4 players for him to Seattle. They gave Dallas all those second-round drafts, or got all those second-round draft choices. They gave one up back for Duke Ferguson, and I think that's the deal, the one person that made the deal for him.
All right, a 3rd of the calling at 6 now, and this crowd very much alive. Ford able to get it away, and he's got a 1st down. Steve Largent, right past that 1st down marker, going sideline on Bobby Jackson, picks it up.
I like it, because he came back for the football. Here we watch Zorn. Stays inside that pocket. We got a blitz by Martin, but he stays in there, steps up. That's where the safe spot is. And Largent came back a good 10 yards to catch that football. No way any defensive back in professional football can stop that bad.
John Yarno leading the Seahawks up to the line. 1st down at the 46-yard line as they work out of the eye. 2nd back, Hunter going wide. Hunter able to turn it across the 40 in Jet territory. Strong safety, Schaefer Suggs, hitting him out of bounds. So Al Hunter out of the eye, the 2nd back after the fake, with a good pickup, makes for a 2nd and 4.
This is exactly what the Jets did the opening of the game. Took the ball, consistently drove it down the field, threw it a little bit, ran with it a little bit. What an exciting ball game. These teams are going to score a lot of points at the end of this day.
Al Hunter, a second-year man out of Notre Dame, comes off a superb rookie season. Oh, quick back open for Sims. He's got the first down and several more. Strong safety, Schaefer Suggs, making the stop on David Sims, and Jim Zorn showing the Jets a bit of the Seahawk running attack.
Yes, and once again, that was over Mr. Klecko. I'm not sure that Mr. Klecko liked that. He may have caught him in a stunt. There's Jack Patera looking for some defense, but he'll settle for the offense that the Seahawks are giving him. Yes, sir.
The Mets leading the Phillies in the second, 2-0. Phillies beating the Mets last night, but the Pirates coming on, and they're hanging in just 3 games back. First down at the 33-yard line. Again, the handoff. This time, Hunter making his way near the 30. Bob Martin able to trip him up. Setting the Seahawks offensive line, Nick Thiebaud and Steve August at the tackles. Tom Lynch, Bob Newton at the guards. The center is John Yarno. Now, John Sawyer has come on at tight end, replacing Ron Howard. There's Sawyer, number 81. And the wide receivers, McCullum, 84, Ferguson, 89, and Rabel, 83. Second and seven. And this is Testament. Don Testament, three-year pro out of Clemson, who has been spotted throughout the afternoon. Stopped by John Hennessy. Testament comes off a strong year, averaging 4 per carry and catching 31 passes. But he has been shuffled for the most part. It is a third down play, 3rd and 5. At the New York Jet 28, and again the crowd urging the Jet defense on. Here's Zorn going sideline into play. Intended for Ferguson, covered by Taylor. That time, Zorn threw short.
And the Jets blitzed 2 linebackers, made him rush that pass a little bit. I think he could have hung on to it just a second longer, and he probably would have made the reception. He's a little mad at himself. Here comes Mr. Herrera. Well, I'll tell you what now. That's outside of his range. He can't make a field goal from this far away. I would be a bit surprised if he kicked it in the corner. That's 45 yards, plus 7, 52. He'll kick it in the coffin corner.
He has been very successful with angling out punts from field goal formation, but this time, let's see. He's gone for the field goal. Oh, he's got it! Ekron Herrera from long range. So Herrera, who was only 1-for-4 going in, has put the Seahawks up by the score of 17-14, and we'll be back in a moment.
Introducing a truly remarkable concept in automobiles. Sapporo. Introducing Sapporo, a sophisticated sports coupe from Plymouth, with overhead console and digital clock, space-age instrument panel, tilt steering column, many standard luxuries. Sapporo, with our MCA jet system rated at 40 miles per gallon highway, 29 city. Sapporo, sheer pleasure from Plymouth.
Think you can't afford great stereo? Think again. Think of JCPenney's new MCS Series 33-watt system. Think of an incredible everyday saving of $230 when you purchase the 33-watt system as a package. Think of getting $829 worth of magnificent sound components for only $600. JCPenney's MCS Series 33-watt system. Think of the sound. Think of the service. Think of the savings. You won't have to think again.
Airport 77.
I've lost contact with 23 Sierra.
Jack Levis heads an all-star cast in Airport 77, Tuesday at 9, 8 Central and Mountain.
45-yard field goal by Ekron Herrera to give the Seahawks of Seattle the lead for the first time today. As Herrera drills it right through, and Seattle leads it 17-14. Bruce Stevens and Darnell Powell back for this Herrera kickoff, and it's Powell on the return. Powell across the 30-yard line. Bruce Hopper not back there. May have been shaken up earlier today. Hopper is the kickoff and punt return specialist for the Jets. Doug Long in on that stop of Powell, and the Jets now take over at their 29-yard line. And Richard Todd looking to come out of it. He had his problems in the second quarter. He has been intercepted three times in all. He has Durkin and Long at the running backs. Long number 33, Durkin number 25. This is Long. Trying to get outside, gets across the 35, met there by the right cornerback, Dave Brown.
All of a sudden, it appears that both these teams have kind of turned conservative offensively. Why? I'm not sure I understand. The two offensive coordinators for the Jets is John Idzik. For the Seahawks is Jerry Rome. Maybe they figure they're just going to play a little bit here and be a little more conservative and then maybe turn it loose.
Second and four. Outside the 35-yard line. And again, to the running attack and a first down. For Scott Durkin. So Durkin pulling his way up the middle. John Harris, the free safety. Sammy Green, linebacker on the left side, able to collar Durkin.
Well, maybe that's the reason why. We get good yardage up there. Just a couple little trap blocks. He runs into Long. The second effort is getting by his own running back. But he picks up a first down for the Jets, and they're moving the ball well on the ground. This is a passing team.
13-yard pickup for Durkin. First down at the 48-yard line. Again, it's Durkin. He almost lost the handle on the football. Did not have it placed in his hands well, but able to hold on as John Harris, with help from Dennis Boyd, able to bring him down at the Seattle 49-yard line. So an advance of three, and it's a second and seven now for the Jets.
Once again, I say, it appears that both of these teams are turning conservative. Maybe they're a little bit afraid with Todd throwing the three interceptions. Let's not throw it quite so much. They'll still throw it down the field.
All right, Walker left, Gaffney right.
13.
And now Todd to throw. And he throws the middle. He's got one. Inside the 35-yard line, Keith Butler, the linebacker on the right side, stopping Kevin Long. Beautiful run by Long after the reception.
Yeah, and that's the discretion I was talking about with Richard Todd. He's got to look for his backs out of the backfield, especially when Seattle's going to total zone coverage. You can see that Long is his second or third receiver, and then it's up to Mr. Long. And he does a little whirling dervish here for about another 2 or 3 yards. Another first down.
The Jets were very upset by a Buffalo writer last week who wrote that the Jet running backs are a bunch of nobodies. And Walter Michaels was able to make use of that statement on the clubhouse bulletin board. This one of the nobodies, Kevin Long. And Long, again, trying to twist and turn his way for extra yardage. Sammy Green, linebacker on the left side, making the stop. He's an exciting runner.
Yes, he is. And you mentioned the nobodies. I remember a few years ago, there was a defense down in Miami called the No Names. That is some, make them famous, nobodies. Yes, well, not quite so. Mr. Long is having a fine day for himself.
That time he picked up six. Clark Gaines has come on now in that Jet backfield. It's a second and four at the Seattle 26-yard line. The handoff for Gaines, but he is stopped at the line. Hard hit by the middle linebacker, Terry Beeson, as Gaines trying to pull his way through. 4 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in a fast-moving third quarter by virtue of the ground game by both the Seahawks and the Jets.
Interesting statistic. Seattle has been in business for 3 years, and they average 2.5 years NFL experience. The Jets, on the other hand, average 1.7, and they're a veteran football team, supposedly.
Stevens has come in, and wide receiver, rookie out of Columbia, that's Durkin peeling off. Third and three, this is Gaines. Turn in the corner, and he's got the first down. Clark Gaines moving to his right, led by Scott Durkin, his backfield partner, and the strong safety, Autry Beeman, was able to make the stop on number 21, Clark Gaines.
I claim the influence of Kansas City on this play. This is one of the wing T plays where you have a running back in motion. He blocks for the other one. And it's not very pretty, but he picks up 5 yards and a first down. Yes, sir, Marv Levy has an influence on the rest of the NFL.
It's a first down at the Seattle 18. Long is back replacing Gaines. Wesley Walker is back for Bruce Stevens. And again, it's long. That time, he could not get into it, so set a step back, refused to go down, but the whistle had blown, and the play was blown dead. John Harris, the free safety, a name you have been hearing right throughout, and on many of the Seattle tackles, with help from Keith Butler, making the stop.
Yeah, Dennis Long is not particularly big, 6'1", 205, but he shows me tremendous, tremendous ability to keep on his feet. That's a fine day for Mr. Long, 68 yards.
Second and seven at the Seattle 15. Seahawks lead it 17-14 on the 45-yard field goal by Herrera. Working with a straight-ahead move. And he is short of a first down. Scott Durkin, who finished last year very, very strong, was thought of primarily as a blocking back because that's his role at Purdue, but has come on as a strong runner. Sammy Green making the stop on Durkin. And it will be now a third and about two at the 11.
Here we got the big guys in here, the double tight end. And the big running backs with Gaines.
Gaines and Durkin are the running backs. You can hear the crowd as he gets on as Todd and Trevor will fall down. Todd looked to be undecided. And it was Steve Niehaus who was able to come up with the sack. No indecision on the part of the right defensive tackle, Niehaus.
Yeah, and I don't really think we can blame Richard Todd for that. Somebody missed Niehaus cold. He beat the offensive guard to Richard Todd from Notre Dame and probably the most successful high school football team in the nation, Moeller High School in Cincinnati.
It is a 37-yard field goal attempt for Pat Leahy, who has been perfect 4-for-4 thus far this year, and this one is good, and we're tied at 17. Leahy pulling it through the Seattle Seahawks, and the New York Jets are 17 apiece with less than 2 minutes remaining in this third quarter.
The All-American Hot Dog. The ever-popular Frankfurter is but one of hundreds of food products provided by Swift Foods. Swift is part of S-Mart, an American family of companies which also provides fertilizers to make more food available, energy to keep the wheels turning, and consumer products from Playtex. S-Mart, providing over $5 billion worth of needed products annually for you and your world.
Must be ready for a beer.
I'm ready for a new Schlitz Light.
There's a new taste in Schlitz Light. The taste of natural ingredients brewed into a Pilsner beer. New Schlitz Light. Still less filling with a taste that's bigger than light.
We climbed it because it was there.
And we came back down because this was here.
Schlitz Light. Natural Pilsner beer.
Next Saturday, it's down-to-the-wire action as the surging Yankees try to knock off the Indians and the Bucks battle the Expos. Check local listings for the game in your area.
For the New York Jets, 11 plays, 60 yards, consuming 627, and concluding with the 37-yard field goal by Pat Leahy, who is now 5-for-5 in the field goal department. This is Rufus Crawford. And Crawford with an opening. Able to break through just shy of the 35-yard line. He was tripped up with Ricky Grant, backup quarterback, making the stop. And now Zorn and friends go to work. First down at the 35-yard line.
That last graphic is 6 minutes and 27 seconds consumed by the New York Jets, uncharacteristic of the New York Jets. They're not normally a ball control type offense. They throw it down the field and look for points. That's a step in the right direction.
First down at the 35 with a minute 45 remaining in this third quarter. And the handoff for Hunter on the sweep. Al Hunter Able to bring to the 39-yard line. Abdul Salam, the nose tackle, combining with strong safety Schaefer Suggs, making the stop. A look at the Jets defensively. Pillars, Salam, and Pleco up front. Buttle, Hennessy, Hennigan, and Martin are the linebackers as they operate out of the 3-4. Jackson and Taylor at the corners, and Suggs and Owens are the deep men. Second and six now for Seattle at their 39-yard line. McCullum to the right, Largent left. Hunter and Sims are the running backs. And Zorn to throw. Long rush. He's got the screen. He hits Rabel. Rabel was a blocker. Not able to pick up the first down. He's run out by Taylor.
That was a tight end screen. All right, I like that. Rabel coming in there as the third wide receiver. There's a little confusion out there, but this is a fine play. The tight end is really unaccounted for. You see a little game there. The number 63 of the Jets. Unfortunately, Mr. Sims didn't give much help out there, and he only gained about 5 or 6 yards. Tight end screen, though, huh?
There's Steve Rabel, who has been a popular target today for Jim Zorn. Coming into today, had only one reception for 8 yards. This crowd is really juiced up. Once again, working the Jet defense on. It's a third and four for Seattle. High ball game at 17. And Zorn off the short setup. And he's got a first down. Beautiful catch made by number 84, Sam McCullum, who was able to cut back court and pick up the first down with 50 seconds remaining in this third quarter.
Yes, the key phrase, come back for the football. Obviously, these two guys have spent an awful lot of time on this pattern. They've completed it about 5 or 6 times today, and there's really nothing a defensive back can do there because you cover him deep, and then he stops and comes straight back to the quarterback, just enough for the first down. Easy completion.
McCullum right, Largent left. Hunter and Sims are the running backs. Now Zorn off the play action. Going for Hunter. Hunter covered by Buttle, number 51. Really a spectacular circus catch by Al Hunter.
Yeah. It would have been a tough catch. And I think he should have caught that one. That wasn't too bad a pass there, Mr. Zorn. As you see the play coming in from Jerry Rome. Transmitted by Mr. Sawyer. As we go, what is it, second down and 10? I think Hunter should have caught that one. It would have been close, but Buttle once again got his hand up there. Made it hard for the receiver to see the ball.
All right, John Yarno leading the club up. McCullum again right, and Largent left. Second and 10 from the 47-yard line. Someone jumped, penalty marker down, as David Sims brings to the 48 in Jet territory. But you saw that motion in the line. And Gordon McConner will provide the indication. Tie ball game at 17. Offside against the Jets. It looked to be Pleco.
Well, I may have put the bad rap on Joe. But I think you could hear on our mic there the inflection in Zorn's voice. And it's part of football. Defensive coaches tell their defensive linemen, do not listen to the quarterback. Look into the football. There is no excuse for being offsides. And Joe's got his head down there, not very happy. Well,
that was so effective that Trumpy jumped offside. Marv Albert and Bob Trumpy from Shea Stadium in New York. Well, interesting stats on the penalty. Jets have been hard hit.
Two young teams, though. That's going to happen with a young team.
All right, second and 5 now. And again, it's Hunter. Brings inside the 45, short of a first down. Very close, but short. Schaefer Suggs able to stop Hunter, who tried to propel himself through a crowd.
I just noticed something on the Jets defense. Normally, the nose man in a 34 defense is inches away from the offensive center. The nose man for the Jets doesn't seem to be as tight on the center as I've seen other 34 defensive nose men be. I'm not sure if that's by design or if Abdul Salam. I think he's supposed to be up there a little tighter to the center. Be right on it.
And it's a third and one. And David Sims has got the first down and more. Sims down to the 20-yard line. A straight ahead with help. With Sudson Taylor finally bringing Sims down. A big play for Seattle.
And they ran right between Salam and Joe Klecko. Of course, you're going to try to run your offense at the linebackers in this 34 defense because they've got pass responsibility. Good blocking. Good man-on-man blocking right straight up the middle. Sims makes it easy.
On a 31-yard run by Sims, this third quarter has come to a close. We're tied at 17, and we'll be back in just a moment.
Tonight, give that special someone a beautiful rose. Red Rosé, the rose red wine with extraordinary flavor. White wine drinkers like it because it is crisp, light, and very drinkable. But compared to white wine, red rosé has much more character, far more flavor. It is uniquely enjoyable, like a chilled white wine, with more flavor. Gallo Red Rosé.
Style is like no other, and few other cars add more style to it than the new size Chrysler LeBaron. Young, original, individual, Chrysler class, yet sticker priced like Cutlass Supreme, comparably equipped.
Add a little life to your style.
Chrysler LeBaron. Add little life to your style.
Albert and Bob Crumpy from Shea Stadium in New York as we head to the fourth quarter and we're tied at the 17. Some long-range field goals providing the scoring in the third, a 45-yard field goal by Herrera giving the Seahawks a 17-14 lead, and then Leahy answered back from 37 yards out with 2 minutes remaining third quarter. David Sims just unleashed a 31-yard pickup. He is now 15 carries for 90 yards, and Seattle opens up this fourth quarter, first down at the Jet 19-yard line. This is Al Hunter trying to stiff arm his way through. Penalty marker thrown in the secondary. Al Hunter on the slant, stopped by Hennessy and Pillars, but a flag is down.
Second and nine.
Holding against the Seattle Seahawks.
That's illegal use of hands. That doesn't necessarily mean holding, but it may have been that the offensive receiver had his hand on somebody downfield. I'm not sure. I couldn't pick that up. We'll find out, though.
A reminder, next Saturday afternoon, those red-hot New York Yankees going up against the Cleveland Indians in Cleveland. And Pittsburgh and Montreal Pirates, of course, very much alive in that race in the National League East.
And 2 weeks ago when we were in Seattle, the Yankees were 5.5 games out. What are they now? 2.5 up?
3.5.
3.5 up. Amazing. Wonder what Billy Martin's thinking.
All right, first down at 20. At the 29-yard line, and here is Thorne. The throw. See if they call the ball dead. They did. The whistle had blown, so it is no fumble. It is Abdul Salam able to get to Jim Zorn after Zorn was able to elude the first rush of the front three by the New York Jets.
Well, the Jets defense is coming alive here with a couple of blitzes. Let's see what the penalty is going to be. I thought it was face mask. Maybe it's holding. Face mask against the Jets. That'll give them the first down. That was an inadvertent face mask penalty. Good rush here by the Jets. Linebackers coming. And Klecko gets in there. Yes, sir, Joe. And you see Abdul Salam just reaching out to grab the quarterback, as slippery as Zorn is, inadvertently grabs his face mask. That'll be first and 10. That's what I thought.
And we have apologize. The microphone on the field has not been operating, or has been operating upon occasion. So we are reading Gordon McCarter's lips. All right. Seattle. Now first down. At the Jets 29-yard line. First and 10. And Zorn on the handoff for Sam. Sam's able to elude one Jet and another. David Sims with a brilliant run. Such and pillars. Finally bring him down, but I have a feeling that Walter Michaels will not be very pleased with the sloppy tackling of the Jets.
Absolutely, and I didn't think the Statue of Liberty would work twice in one football game, but you're going to see the Statue of Liberty work twice very well in one football game. Good blocking, and it is sloppy tackling. Let's call it as it is. Should have been stopped back there. That was just a fine move. Well, the Seahawks are rolling.
Hesterman has come on out of the line with Hunter. First down at the Jets 17-yard line. He gave it for Hesterman, and he is stopped by a wall. With Pillar, Salam, and Klecko not allowing Kesterman to make his move.
But it's going to be first down and 5 because the Jets were a little too anxious. Looked like an all-out blitz there. And they were caught over the line. Yes, sir, Coach Michaels. Very stern coach. Wants discipline on his football team. And that's something the Jets really haven't had in the last 5 or 6 years, discipline. He's building from within. And he's a fine coach, defensive-oriented, and has a great deal of faith in his players, and the players have a great deal of faith in him. This should be a nice relationship for the Jets and Walt Michaels for many years.
Well, the Red Sox, who are trying to avert a Yankee sweep, lead the Yankees 1-0 in the fourth inning up at Yankee Stadium. And Gordon McCarter with the indication. Making for the first down. Hunter and Sims are the running backs. And the handoff for Sims. And Sims brings inside the 10-yard line. We'll have to wait and see where his forward progress was stopped. Schaefer Suggs in on the tackle along with the nose tackle Abdul Salam. Right here, let's pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC Television Network.
This is Channel 5, KING TV, Seattle.
Unfortunately, on that play, it appears that Steve August, first-round draft choice 2 years ago, is hurt badly. And that kept him out of the lineup last year with a bad ankle. And he's grabbing it again. It will return after this.
The arrester has come to town. The zinc-coated double-wrap muffler from Kmart. Have it installed by Kmart. And if anything goes wrong, they'll replace it free for as long as you own your American-made car.
Like other great car products, it's Kmart prized.
Kmart's Arrester, a very inexpensive way to lock away noise.
This is Uniflow Motor Oil from Exxon. Change to it, and after break-in, here's what it could do for you. It could save you money because it could save you gas. About $2 worth for each quart it takes to make the change. That amounts to a gas savings of about $10 between oil changes. Uniflow from Exxon saves money, saves gas. Change after change after change after change after change.
Upcoming here on NBC next Sunday, a full slate of National Football League action, starting with NFL 78 at 12:30. Steve August replaced by Norm Evans at right tackle. It is a second and about 2 for Seattle down at the Jet 9-yard line. We're tied at 17. And Zorn takes it himself on a keeper.
Amazing.
Beautiful fake by Zorn. And he has picked up the first down. First and goal now for the Seahawks. Schaefer Sugg making the tackle on Zorn, but a penalty marker down. And a it's going to be called back, a hold against Seattle.
As I said in the first half, Jim Zorn and the Seattle Seahawks will do absolutely anything to get the ball up the field. This is a broken play, and they gained 6 yards. Well, when things are going your way, that's what happens. But it's all for naught, holding on somebody. And we'll never find out who. I'm not so sure that's not a good idea. I never liked the official telling everybody in the stands that I was holding somebody.
You're talking from the player point of view.
Well, of course, I've got to.
As a reporter now, Bob, you want to know. Come on.
Okay.
All right, second down for Vaughn, who throws to the corner. Great catch made by Larkin. Covered by Owens, but again, a penalty marker is down. Leaping catch by Steve Largent.
That flag is going to be defensive pass interference on the Jets. They're going to have the Seahawks are going to have the ball first and goal. Talking to Norm Evans, he replaced Steve August. And of course, he is one of 7 veterans left out of the veteran allocation for the Seattle Seahawks. He came from Miami, was the captain of Miami's football team, as we watch again. And what a replacement for a young man. Well, you can't really see the pass interference, but it was on the guy covering Duke Ferguson, Schaefer Sugg, on Eddie Taylor.
All right, the official.
It was on Schaefer Suggs, number 23. We didn't see it in the. Yeah, we didn't see it in the picture. Shame on you. Trying to get away with things like that. Well, that's that rule that you can't touch them down the field. Schaefer Suggs, number 23. First and 10.
So, first down at the 14-yard line. 15 minutes remaining fourth quarter. Jets and Seattle are tied at 17. Sim and Hunter are the setbacks. That's Sim. David Sim, who has hit the 100-yard mark today, over 15 carries. And he was stopped by Lawrence Pillars. Yes, penalties have certainly played a major role today. Jets, 59 yards penalized. Seahawks, 30 yards.
Once again, I wonder why the conservatism in both of these offenses. As Norm Evans comes off, Steve August goes back on. That's a refreshing sight for Seattle fans. August seems to be okay. He was holding his ankle, obviously not hurt too bad.
Second and 5 from the 9, and Testerman bottled up after picking up short yardage. Hennessy and Hennigan combined to make the stop. Pillars, Salam, Klecko up front. Buttle, Hennessy, Hennigan, and Martin are the linebackers. Taylor and Jackson in the corners, and Suggs and Owens are the deep men.
I think Steve August went off and got his ankle retaped. Looks like he's got a bunch of tape on the outside of his foot. But he's ready to play again. Big down coming here for Seattle and for New York.
Head of defense from this big crowd here at Shea Stadium, and a timeout is called by Seattle, and Zorn will talk it over with a 3rd and 2 from the 7. Seattle and New York are tied at 17. 2 touchdowns apiece for Clark Gaines and David Sims, and a 45-yard field goal by Efren Herrera, a 37-yard field goal by Pat Leahy. And that's the story. With 12 minutes remaining in this fourth quarter, we'll return right after we hear these messages.
3 unidentified 19-inch color TV pictures, each the best of its brand. Over 1,000 people saw them and picked the one with the best overall picture. They didn't pick America's biggest seller, Zenith, or the second biggest, RCA. Over 60% picked the 19-inch Sylvania Superset. Over 60%. We're not the biggest, but a lot of people think we've got the best picture. The Sylvania Superset.
From Marina Del Rey to Marblehead, even landlubbers know the best thing to sail into.
Beer makes it good.
It's just one Schlitz.
There's no debate.
Nothing else comes near.
Beer makes it good.
When you're out of Schlitz,
Schlitz makes it great.
You're out of beer.
Nobody makes it like Schlitz. Every drop chill lagered for quality. 11 million times a day, America reaches for a Schlitz. Because since 1849, Schlitz makes it great.
So when it comes to beer, why make it good? Schlitz makes it like no other could. Schlitz makes it great.
We have 12 minutes left, fourth quarter. Seattle, third and two at the Jets' seven. The Seahawks and the Jets are tied at 17. Tucker and Kesterman are the running backs. And here is Jim Thorne. Thorne throwing, and he completes. Launcher belted out of bounds by Jackson. And let's see where they mark it.
Short of the first down, he didn't make it. That seems like an awful lot of effort to try to make 4 yards. Largent was lined up on the right side of the line of scrimmage, came back behind the line of scrimmage. You see him in the bottom of your picture, number 80. He comes across the line, then tries to get downfield. I don't like that call. The way they've been running the ball, give it to Testament or give it to Sims, and hit it. The shortest distance between 2 points is a straight line. That's what my geometry teacher told me.
So short of the first down, and Herrera now will try from 25 yards away. Thorne, oh, no, it's a fake, and here's Thorne on the run, and Thorne has picked up the first down. A field goal fake, and Jim Thorne picks up the first down, first and goal for Seattle.
I like it. Now, I want to tell you, there's no pressure on this football team to win. I'm talking about the Seattle Seahawks. They're building for the future, and they're doing it in good time. And they'll do anything to get the ball in the end zone. And this is, it was designed as a pass. Thorne, excellent scrambler, picks up the first down, took the Jets totally by surprise. I love it. They'll do anything.
So it is a first and goal for the Seahawks. Down at the 3 yard line. Testament and Sims, the running back. This is Sims, and he is stacked up. He is stopped. Wacko in on the tackle. It will be second and goal.
A little bit of misdirection there, but it didn't work. Excellent job by the New York Jets to stop him inside the 5 yard line. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if they threw it now or come to the triple option. They scored on it once. All kinds of possibilities. Quarterback draw, anything. Let's see what Mr. Thorne comes up with.
Second and goal, still at the three. The pitch out for Sims. He's got an opening, and he's in. The Seahawks have taken the lead, but a penalty marker is thrown down. Against the Jets for a personal foul, so the touchdown holds up. And the Seahawks have jumped in front, 23-17. David Sims with his third TD of the afternoon.
And it's the triple option, one of the choices we gave you. There you see Buttle. Oh, but the personal foul was on Buttle. He hit Thorne again right in the face. And once again, I say, if he does it once, maybe it's all right. You should find him. If he does it twice, he should be out of the football game. No place in football for things like that. You take Thorne out of the game, he's one of the most exciting football players there is in the NFL. It takes away from the game. You don't want it. That's bad. He's a better football player than that. I'm surprised.
Now the try for the punt after by Herrera with Thorne holding. And the Seahawks now lead the Jets by the score of 24-17. 10:20 remaining fourth quarter. We'll be back at Shea right after these words.
Handling in a small car?
Relax, Horizon can handle it.
You seem to have a lot of control over where you're going and what you're doing.
I do patient visiting on some pretty treacherous roads, and it handles nicely.
It has good pickup on the expressway. It really performs well.
Responsive handling plus room and comfort. No wonder Motor Trend magazine calls Plymouth Horizon Car of the Year.
Relax, Horizon can handle it.
Sears National Automotive Values. Only $99 to $119 gets you not one, not two, not three, but four new four-ply tires for most subcompacts to full-size cars. $99 to $119. Now on sale, the Sears 36 battery. Loaded with starting power and it's maintenance-free. At only $27.99 with trade-in, you save $7 on Sears 36 battery. At Sears.
Nobody offers Super Saver discount fares to so much of this land as United. United built the largest airline in the free world around you.
There's Matt Robinson warming up for the New York Jets. We might see a replacement for Richard Todd as you look at that Seahawk drive, 6:38. That is called ball control.
Yes, sir.
And the key play, that field goal fake, with Zorn able to pick up the first down off the penalty. The kickoff comes from the 50, and here's Bruce Stevens on to the turn, the rookie free agent out of Columbia, who is the fastest man on the squad. That's Stevens to the 50, Stevens to the 40, and all the way down across the 35-yard line, but a penalty marker has been thrown down. Way downfield, a flag on the play.
It's going to be taken all the way back, Mars. It's clipping on the Jets. Now, you know, it's amazing how things like this happen. 15 yards added holding against the Jets. 15 yards added assessed on the kickoff. Normally, you think you're not going to have a chance to get a good return. Sometimes when a guy bobbles the ball on the kickoff return, he seems to make more yards. Incredible, but it's all for naught. And you see the end of it. Excellent speed. The fastest guy on the Jets team. Well, he should have saved some of it. Take it all the way back.
And Bob, I'm told it is a clip on Clark Gaines that has brought it back. So Bruce Stevens with a nice run, but will not count. And you can hear the reaction from the crowd.
That's holding. That's holding on the Jets.
Gaines is called for the hold, and the Jets hemmed in. Richard Todd is still in there, first and 10 now, from the Jets' six-yard line. Seahawks leading 24-17. Here's Kevin Long, and Long trying to go up the middle is stopped. Dennis Boyd, the left defensive tackle, making the stop. Head coach Walt Michaels, not particularly happy at this point. Seahawks beat the Jets here last year 17-0. Next Sunday here on NBC, a full slate of action. 12:30 it gets underway with NFL 78. And there you see our lineup. It is a second and six from the 10-yard line. Again, it is long. A hard pop by Bill Sandifer, the left defensive end, on Kevin Long.
A fine tackle, too, but I wonder why the Jets have suddenly turned so conservative. As you watch, a nice kiss. Yes, sir. To the ground you go, sir. Why are they so conservative? I mean, the first drive that they had, they threw the ball. The first drive in the game, they threw the ball very well. I wonder if there's something wrong with Todd.
Aside from three interceptions.
Yes. True.
All right, third and two now for Todd, and he fires, and he's got a first down. He's got Darius Gaffney, and Gaffney is wrestled out of bounds in front of the jet back. And as you can hear from the crowd, and you see over at the far side, Jet fans and Jet players taking exception to that hit by Cornell Webster. Of course, the Seahawks can say, what about Greg Buddle?
Yes, that was a legal tackle. I don't mind that as much as I like the other stuff. Well, I guess they're going to just throw the ball on possession downs. This is a fine tie-up here between Gaffney and Todd once again. I don't know how you can possibly cover him if you're a defensive back with that kid speed. The reason that looks so bad is he grabs him by the shoulder pads. He's all right. There's nothing illegal about that.
All right, Gaines has come on replacing Long. That's Durkin Peeling. First down at the 31. And Todd to throw on first down. He's got the screen out, but the play is whistled dead. Looked like he scooped it up, although Gaines is arguing. Niehaus makes the stop. Gaines claiming that he caught it cleanly. He did not short hop it.
He doesn't have a choice, though. It's not his responsibility to determine whether or not he caught the ball.
Todd is very good at setting up screen passes. And I'll call it for you. It hit the ground. The referee made the right call. And Gaines probably knew it. But it's part of the job to complain.
Second and ten. Todd throws the ball, but Walker not able to hold on. Covered by Dave Brown, number 22.
Now, I was hoping this would come up, because the rap against Wesley Walker is that he doesn't catch the ball well consistently enough. Somebody's got to get with that young man and say, look, you can catch the ball deep, but you've got to work on your intermediate batters, distances of 10 or 15 yards. If you can catch the ball in there consistently, it's going to make you three times the receiver deep, because they don't know where to sit for you. And that ball should have been caught. It was low, but that was a catchable ball.
And Walker had a dropsy problem last year. Not the problem over his first two games this season. It is now third and ten. And Todd goes to middle again. It's nearly intercepted. Broken up beautifully by Cornell Webster. The intended receiver was Derek Gaffney. And the Jet drive a stump. So Chuck Ramsey comes on with 8 minutes and 29 seconds remaining on the fourth quarter. And the Jets will get the ball back to Seattle.
Well, Webster almost picked this one off. I should say that one off.
The deep man is John Harris. It is a 10-man rush for Seattle. Ramsey averaging 45 yards per punt. Second in the AFC to Ray Guy of Oakland. Has come a long way from last year. Able to get a good one off. Here's Harris. To the 30. Lost his footing. And taken down, but a penalty marker is down. Like a face mask once again. Larry Keller in on the tackle.
You got it right, Marv. He inadvertently grabbed a hold of his face mask. That happens sometimes. Harris looks hurt, too. Twisted his ankle a little bit, it looks like. But he's okay.
There he is. John Harris. Seventh round draft pick, rookie out of Arizona State.
Head coach Jack Patera. Now, let's see if you're the Seattle Seahawks, their last drive, I think, consumed 6 minutes and 37 seconds.
Right.
You want to come back with the same kind of ball control. There's 8:16 left to go in the football game. You're leading by 7 points. You go conservative. We still have no audio from the officials, but it is a face mask penalty against the Jets. But anyway, you go to your conservative type offense. The Jets have got to come up with a ball. They got to get an interception, a fumble or something, and try to get back in this ball game.
Seattle looking for its first victory of the season, losing two tough ones at home to San Diego 24-20 last week in Pittsburgh 21-10. First down at their 39. They lead the Jets 24-17. Al Hunter not able to go anywhere. Hunter running into a crowd. Lawrence Pillar making the stop on Hunter.
Well, it's obvious the Jets know what they have to do. Stop Seattle. Try to get a turnover, but don't let him get any yardage. But here's the thing, though. The Seahawks have a great weapon in Jim Zorn in that he can run the ball. And defenses don't account for the quarterback running the ball. Going into this game, he was the Seahawks' second leading rusher after two games, which is rather incredible. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens here. You might see Zorn take off by himself.
Lodgen in the slot to the right. Ferguson, flank to the right. Second and 11. Zorn to throw. Zorn throwing to Lodgett. And it is broken up by Jackson. Bobby Jackson claiming that there should have been interference on Lodgett.
We can hear him all the way up here. We talked about discretion at halftime of Richard Todd. I'm not sure this pass should have been thrown. They had a total defense, total coverage. 8 guys back there to cover 3. I don't think I'd have thrown this. I don't think there's any interference here. They're both going for the football. No. No way. No way. Good call by the official. In fact, in the fact that there was no call by the official.
And as a third and 11. Seattle at its 38-yard line. 7:20 left fourth quarter. And Zorn to throw again. Over the middle, he's got Largent, but short of a first down. Stopped by Mike Hennigan. And so the Jets will get the ball back. The Seahawks drive is stopped. Bruce Stevens, the drop back in single safety. Bruce Harper apparently was shaken up earlier today and has not seen action in the second half.
I'll bet we see the Jets throw the ball this time. They got to get back in this ballgame. 6:45 left to go, trailing by 7 points.
Here's Stevens awaiting the Herman Weaver punt. Takes the Seattle bounce, and it's down inside the 5-yard line by Doug Long.
There couldn't have been a better time for a kick like that. Dead on the 4-yard line, make it the 5-yard line. The Jets got first and 96.
And there's a timeout. Seattle up 24-17. We'll be back in a moment.
Yeah, let's have a new Schlitz Light.
There's a new taste in Schlitz Light. The taste of natural ingredients brewed into a Pilsner beer. New Schlitz Light. Still less filling with a taste that's bigger than light.
Think we won?
Well, it's not whether you win or lose.
It's the beer you choose.
Schlitz Light. Natural Pilsner beer.
Your engine isn't starting on cue. Put in a fresh set of Champion spark plugs at least once a year. Champion and your engine can make beautiful music together. You can't buy a better plug.
Love is in the air.
You look beautiful.
But so is trouble.
She's blind too.
On Little House on the Prairie, Monday.
Marv Albert and Bob Trumpy from Shea Stadium in New York. 51-yard punt by Herman Weaver, setting up the Jets' first and 10 back at their 5-yard line. Richard Todd with the handoff. And nice move off the left side by Scott Durkin for a first down. Sammy Green, left linebacker, with help from John Harris, the free safety, making the stop on Durkin.
I've noticed one thing about the Jets' offense when they run it. They like to go over Chris Ward from Ohio State, their number one draft choice this year. And he's one of the bookends, the other one being Marvin Powell, a first-round draft choice last year from USC.
And now Durkin combining with Gaines in that Jet backfield. Richard Todd with the handoff. Clark Gaines finds an opening. Gaines has seen considerable action here in the second half. Dennis Boyd, the left defensive tackle, making the stop on the play.
And run again at about the same spot. Over Chris Ward, former Buckeye. Turn Jet.
Chris Ward had to, I would think, be wondering what was happening yesterday. Woody Hayes threw the football.
Yes.
Consistently and lost.
That's what he said would happen.
5:20 remaining fourth quarter. And once again, the handoff. And it's Gaines with a great second effort going to the outside. Gaines to the 50, to the 45. And hit out of bounds. Spectacular move by Gaines. It appeared they had him.
Talk about second effort. He was dead stopped at the line of scrimmage. But the Jets, with those big offensive linemen, what they try to do is cut somebody off on the backside. Give those running backs a chance to cut back against the grain, and this is exactly what we're talking about. Watch him hit right up in there. Dead stop by Steve Niehaus. And they cut off the pursuit, and he's gone. Good speed, too. Good speed.
37-yard run by Gaines. Gaines, a guy who year after year has had to prove himself. Free agent pickup from Wake Forest. First out of the 43, and Todd to throw. Fires deep downfield for Walker, and it is broken up. He was double covered that time, and Dave Brown, number 22, was able to battle away. You see Harrison Brown breathing collective sighs of relief.
Almost. Every day in a pregame show about how many times he's going to throw it deep. Good defense by Seattle. He was double covered. I'm surprised he didn't try to throw it to Gaffney. But nevertheless, they're going to do that again before the game is over. They got to get 7 points and get them in a hurry.
Coming up following the Jets and Seahawks, complete rundown of the scores around the National Football League on the NFL Report. Bobby Jones now has come in at wide receiver, flanked to the left. It is a 2nd and 10 at the Seattle 43. Jets trail by 7, 24-17. And Todd dumps it over the middle. Kevin Long not able to hold on. That's a big play. Green and Butler covering. And this makes for a 3rd and 10.
Took his eye off of it, Marv. And there's the man that threw it. I'm sure he's saying, well, now he's getting some input from the sidelines, it appears. They're alternating wide receivers. Gaffney comes in with the play. That should have been caught.
Todd is now 10 for 21, 207 yards. At Yankee Stadium in the 5th, the Red Sox lead the Yankees 2-0, looking to avert that sweep. Yankees losing them 4 last week at Fenway, and they won the 1st 2 of this series. 3rd down and 10. And Todd, looking to elude Gregory, gets it away. He's got Gershon, but no 1st down. Considerably short, as Humphrey Beeman was all over Scott Gershon. Bill Gregory had a couple of opportunities with Todd. Todd was able to get away, but forced the throw. And the crowd urging the Jets to go for it with 4:35 remaining in this 4th quarter. And the Jets will go for it. Not looking to give up the football. Trailing here, 24-17. Kevin Long checks back in.
This is the game right here. They make a 1st down. They got a good chance. Look for one of the backs out of the backfield, Mark. And the Jets fans love it. 4th and 6.
Long and Turkin are the running backs. 4th and 6 for Tom.
He's got him.
That has got the 1st down. Kevin Long. Again with the 2nd effort, pulling his way forward. They are calling for the yardsticks. From this angle, it appears that Long has picked it up.
Well, now it's really up to the official where he spots it. That's all we're going to wait for. And once again, Long out of the backfield. Very smart move. You watch Todd take his time on this one. He waits, he waits, he waits. Gives those linebackers a chance to get real deep. This is going to be a close measurement. Very close. It could be the ball game. They got it. They got it. Here we go.
The Jets on a 4th and 6 pick up the 1st down as Kevin Long, who dropped one over the middle just a moment ago, was able to snare one and pick it up. So the Jets now 1st down at the Seattle 33-yard line. They are trailing 24-17. Seattle looking for its 1st victory of the year. Jets looking to go 3-0. The handoff is for Long. And over the left side, inside the 30-yard line, stopped by Dennis Boyd. They left defensive tackle. Sandifer, Boyd, Niehaus, and Roche up front. Green, Beeson, and Butler are the linebackers. Brown and Webster are the cornerbacks, and Beeman and Harris are the deep men. Last Sunday at Buffalo, Jets have come from behind to pick up the victory, and they are being urged down by the lively crowd right throughout the day. 3:10 to go, 4th quarter. And Scott Gershon able to dive to the 25-yard line.
Now I'm going to ask you a question. You're from New York. Have you heard the Jet fans cheer like this in the last 5 or 6 years?
Bob, I tell you, the Jets have not had any fans to do any cheering, I tell you.
That's my point. You think they don't like this 2-0 record? And so does Walt Michaels. 3rd and 2, another big play.
So from the 25, 3rd and 2. They go with the 3 tight ends, Parker, Schuler, and River. And the handoff is Gaines. Penalty marker down as Gaines brings close to the 1st down marker. Peter Cronin making the stop. And let's see what this flag is all about.
They got him for holding, Marv. And
the Jets know it. And he had the first down. Well, now it's really a tough spot. This is when you want the coach calling the play for you. It's going to be third down and I'd say 12 maybe. You want this play to come from the head coach himself.
2 minutes and 28 seconds remaining fourth quarter. A holding call. Jets have been severely hit by penalties. Again, we apologize. The referee's mic not operating. A big penalty on Clark Gaines on a kickoff return by Bruce Stevens, who broke one. It is now a third and 12. Durkin peeling off. And Todd to the air. He's got Durkin. And Durkin is pulled down at the 30-yard line, short of a first down by 7 yards. Cornell Webster, the left cornerback, making the stop. 2 minutes, 12 seconds left, fourth quarter.
Here we go again. Fourth down, and this time it's going to be 8. I look for the same pass to get to Mr. Long. Why not? It worked before. We'll see what happens, though. 2 minute warning.
So a timeout call with the 2 minute warning provided. And when we return, another big play upcoming for Richard Todd and the New York Jets. Seattle leading it 24-17. We'll be right back.
I gotta get through. The guys are counting on me. Likely we rented this truck. It's a Ryder. Ryder rents at least as tough trucks. They keep on going. Church had never heard the word quit.
Hey, fellas, he made it!
I made it! I made it! They said it couldn't be done, but I made it! I drove the truck. I drove you! You're my truck! We're a team! I love you, truck!
Protecting your car radiator against freezing up when it's freezing outside? That's the mark of Xerex. Xerex antifreeze. Protecting your radiator against boiling over when it's boiling outside. That's the mark of Xerex. Protecting your radiator against rust, no matter what it's doing outside. That's the mark of Xerex. Three-way protection all year long. That's the mark of Xerex.
See live regional coverage of hard-hitting NFL football action starting with NFL 78 next Sunday on NBC. Check local listings for the game in your area.
2 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. Jets now fourth and 7 at the Seattle 30-yard line. Seahawks leading 24-17. And here's the play. The Seahawks come up very big. Bill Gregory, number 77. The longtime Dallas Cowboy, making his first start for Seattle this afternoon, gets to the quarterback Richard Todd to end this Jet drive. The Seahawks will take over.
And Jack Matera is smiling. I can't believe it. Bill Watts, Bill Gregory on Chris Ward. Experience against the rookie. That's on Chris Ward. No way. No way.
And there's a timeout call. We'll be back in just a moment.
You should have used Mobil 1, dummy. The oil, it saves you gas.
You could have gone up to 10 extra miles, darling.
On every tank full of gas, my son.
Mobil 1 reduces friction so well it can take the average car up to 10 extra miles per tank full.
Hey, man, what's holding everything up?
Some dummy ran out of gas. Didn't use Mobil 1.
The oil that saves you gas also saves you oil changes.
From El Paso to Cheyenne, the West was wild once, and sometimes it still is.
Beer makes it good.
Beer's just one Schlitz.
There's no debate.
Nothing else comes near.
Beer makes it good.
When you're out of Schlitz,
Schlitz makes it great.
You're out of beer.
11 million times a day, America reaches for a Schlitz. Every drop chill lagered for quality since 1849.
Schlitz makes it like no other good. Schlitz makes it great.
That is the time remaining in this fourth quarter here at Shea as you look at Bill Gregory. The man who sacked Richard Todd to stop the Jets on 4th and 7 from the Seattle 30. Now, Seattle first down at their 40-yard line, and Thorne will try to run out the clock. The handoff to Hunter, and he is dropped by Pillars. So Lawrence Pillars, number 76, three-year pro out of Alcorn State, man with great speed for 6'3", 250 pounds, getting to Al Hunter.
This game's not over, Marv. The Jets have got three timeouts. They just took one, so they're going to have two left. If they can stop them, maybe rush the punter. I mean, let's be positive about this. Let's make it dramatic. I don't want to disappoint the Seattle fans, but it's not over yet. All right.
Rick Buttle talking things over with Jet head coach Walt Michael. It is a 2nd and 15 for Seattle back at the 35-yard line. Setting the Jets defensively, Pillars, Salam, and Klecko up front. As you see, a 1:49 remaining in this fourth quarter. Buttle, Hennessy, Hennigan, and Martin are the linebackers. Jackson and Taylor at the corners. And Suggs, the strong safety. Now Ken Troy is in at free safety. 2nd and 15 for Zorn. Hunter and Sims are the running backs. The handoff for Sims, trying to pick his way through, but he stopped short yardage as Salam was able to trip him up. David Sims has had a tremendous day. He has scored all three Seattle touchdowns. He has surpassed the 100-yard mark. 19 carries for 109 yards thus far. But he was stopped that time by Salam. And there's a timeout call. We'll return right after these words.
I joined the move to Michelin.
I joined the move to Michelin.
I joined the move to Michelin.
You should too. Michelin's the one that introduced the radio. And Michelin makes only radios. Michelin's the one that's made radios longer than anybody else in the world. Michelin's the one to insist on.
Join the move to Michelin.
For real tire satisfaction, think Michelin first. We're second to none.
Cordova is truly an amazing automobile. So elegant, so luxurious, yet it responds so quickly, so effortlessly to your touch. Cordova's beauty of design is obvious, but to appreciate its real beauty, you must drive it. I promise you a most exciting experience.
Following the Jets and the Seahawks here on NBC, the Sperry NFL Report. It is a 3rd and 13 now for Zorn of the Seahawks. And at 45 left fourth quarter, Sims flying the left side. And he is stopped, but a penalty marker is down. It is in the secondary. Bob Martin making the stop on Sims as he tried to turn the corner but could not. And Seahawk players are applauding, which would indicate that the penalty will be upcoming against the Jets.
Pass interference, Jets. I don't believe it. Boy, whoever did that's going to be in trouble. That is no good. And this is the Statue of Liberty again. Illegal use of the hands by the Jets. I can't really see it on that play. It was thrown on the other side of the field. May have been an illegal chuck, but if that's true, the official didn't see the guy run. I don't know that that's a right call. He's going to call pass interference. Well, I don't know how you can do that. Unless maybe the quarterback looks like he's going to throw it when he hands it off. Mr. Michaels, you have a point of question, sir.
The Jets have killed themselves on penalties right throughout. It is a first down for Seattle at their 45. Sims again takes the handoff and will go 7-8 yards on the play. Schaefer Suggs, a strong safety, making the stop. The Jets have only one timeout remaining. So the clock is running. 1:20 left in this fourth quarter. And Seattle leading it 24-17 on 3 touchdowns by David Sims and a 45-yard field goal by Efren Herrera. Seattle looking to go in the books with their first win of this 1978 season. Second and 3. And again, it is Sims stopped short of the first down. Picked up a yard on the play. Klecko there to make the stop. And now the Jets use their final timeout. They stop the clock with 49 seconds left.
Marv, just a point of interest. Next week, Seattle plays the Detroit Lions in Seattle. The Jets will travel to RFK Stadium and play the Washington Redskins. And I don't think the Jets have anything to be ashamed of. 2-0, Walt Michaels should be very happy with this team, except for a couple of dumb penalties and 3 interceptions by Richard Todd. They haven't really played that bad. They're still going to be at least tied for first in the AFC East. The Seattle Seahawks, on the other hand, are an excellent football team, building for the future. And there's nothing wrong with winning their first game, and I want to tell you, that trip back to Seattle, which is a long one, is going to be very nice for these guys. It's always fun to ride home a winner, and it makes the soreness feel a little better. You don't hurt quite as bad when you win, and they are going to be sore. It was hot out there today playing this football game. And the Seahawks looking to make it 2 out of 2 here at Shea over the Jets, beating the Jets last year 17-0. Once again, Sims, he is stacked up. And we'll wait for them to unravel. That clock continues to run, though. That is time remaining in this fourth quarter. With the Seahawks leading at 24-17. Sims just shy of a first down. Now, 22 seconds remaining. Seahawks in no hurry at all. But they've got to run a play, Marv. They got about 4 seconds on the clock. They're going to have to run a play, and it'd be a mistake if they didn't. But that'll stop the clock.
All right, you see it counting down.
That's a mistake.
There's a delay of game.
Now you see that the clock doesn't start until the ball is snapped. That's a mistake, and it's fourth down, and the change of possession, the clock stops again. The New York Jets are going to have 1 play left.
Yeah. Yeah. 2 seconds remaining.
They have reset the clock. It shows 4 now. Play of game. Off this delay of game, it is placed back to the 49-yard line.
I should say the Jets might have another play. The fans don't think so. They're heading for the freeway.
All right, the Seahawks now to the line. And Zorn will just sit on it right here.
Okay, they should have another play. Oh, I don't know about that.
Well, the unofficial clock, which is what you see in the left-hand corner of your screen, showed 4 seconds, and the announcement on the public address said there are 3 seconds left, but the official clock is the one that the
I understand.
Referee Gordon McCarter